All in a day's work for the Squadron Supreme, Earth's mightiest heroes.
We got it locked from your block to the comic shop.
Listen, share, rate, and subscribe to Hip Hop Marvel's podcast, available on all podcast platforms and apps and streaming services. Available on Pandora, Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google Podcasts, and more.
Yo, this your boy Frank Nitt. And this rules if you want to get in this Marvel Studios. Don't nobody get in this motherfucker. So rule number one, don't pop your ass up. Don't bring no extra niggas. And you better be ready to write, direct, produce some hot shit, or you will not get in. Marvel Studios, nigga, you know what it is. Frank Nitt, let's go.
We got it locked from your block to the comic shop.
Fine. I'll do it myself.
One, two, one, two. Hip-hop marbles. Marvelous, Marvin Hagler versus Hearns. Whenever bash, take turns on verses. Curses on whoever stepping near the bomb epicenter. The inventors are hallways y'all can't enter. So any villain type of step up, he get injured. We pull out pins and link up like the defenders.
The end of your role, playboy, of course you're center the fold. I'm Bobby Drake versus Froze like I invented the cold. You can't hold a candle to us with too much, you screw up. The podcast will tell you something good like Rufus. And we don't give two fucks. We'll bash your territory, get the cash and the glory while the grill tells my story.
It's getting gory, the blood, sweat, and tears took us farther. When great minds think alike, a bonding onslaughter. Xavier types that Magneto grip the microphone. Scott Summer stare a human down if I don't like its own. Metal on me like I'm Dr. Doom, peace to Victor Bond. We marvelous on any beat we choose to spit upon. Bash.
It's your boy Dub Floyd in the place to be, and in the place to be is Dub Floyd, and this is Hip Hop Marvel's podcast, your friendly neighborhood club for all things hip hop and Marvel, where we got it locked from the block to the comic shop. And this is episode 4040, episode 40, and we call this one here, What You Got On My 40, Homie.
What You Got On My 40, Homie.
What You Got On My 40, Homie. Yeah.
And to the left of me, we have
Pat Mully, the Beat Bully. What's good, y'all?
Mully the Bully.
To the right of me, we have,
you know, you got your boy E-Ray, a.k.a. Filmo Thick, and you know how I like him.
How you like him?
Slim thick with tapered ankles all day.
All day.
All day. And I know you heard that voice on the line. On the line we have...
This is Rick 0378, a.k.a. The Collector, a.k.a. Brother Zero, a.k.a. Fuck what you heard. I'm Rick Grimes, bitch.
Rick the Ruler.
We got to, and we also have to add, AKA Slick Rick Fury. You know what I'm saying? Slick Rick Fury. They both got eye patches.
Yes, sir. Coming you know to you saying? Live via fiber optics.
Yes,
right,
sir.
Right. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, man. I know it's been a minute. You know, maybe we back at it, back here. You know, we got a portion of the crew. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Just want to let the fans know, you know, to listen, share, rate, and subscribe. Where everywhere you get your podcast, across the board, you name it, we're there. Just type in Hip Hop Marvels. You can hit us up on our social media. You know what I'm saying? That's at Hip Hop Marvels on Twitter. Well, X now. I can't stand that shit.
Yeah,
but
that's stupid.
X. And on Instagram, that's at Hip Hop Marvels. And that's Hip Hop Marvels, all one word, on Facebook.
Yeah.
Don't forget to hit the YouTube up. Run them numbers up. Subscribe. We're coming to you damn near every week now with new content, you know, new visuals up.
I just want to thank everybody, too. Quick thanks to everybody who's viewed us. Thanks to our subscribers. Please, everybody, subscribe. Hit the bell so you can know when the next one coming through. And just again, thank you guys. We couldn't ask for more.
Thank you. Thank
download
you.
Download too.
Yeah.
Download.
Yeah. Yes. Share. Definitely share with your partners.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. If you have you know partners that are, you got me saying partners. if you got partners,
yeah,
that's into, you know, hip hop, that's into Marvel, We're the best of both worlds. Yeah. We bring those two worlds together here at my Marvel's podcast. So, you know,
holla at us. We holla back.
Yeah,
we definitely do.
Really do.
And shout out C Red. Shout out to you. And shout out to King Rhodes. I'm gonna get with y'all. We can do something. Me and Dub talked about it and Pat and y'all. So we'll get with y'all. Do something, man.
Yeah, yeah, most definitely. Mm-hmm. And you know, we gotta send a shout out to the rest of the squad. Rest of the Squadron Supreme. So, you know, big shout. Yeah, yeah, definitely. Big shout out to Wizzy.
Wizzy, you a genius, partner.
You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Producer, cameraman, extraordinaire. You know what I'm saying? Have to give a big shout out to Wizzy. Big shout out to Jigpool.
Jig.
What up,
all
Jig?
All things Deadpool.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Big shout out to Jigpool and to Brandis. Big shout out to Brandis.
Princess Brandis.
And last but not least, Double T. You know
Dub
what I'm saying? Dub T. Big shout out to Double T, Terry. Shout out to him. So, you know, yeah, that's the Squadron Supreme.
Doing
you know
big
what I mean?
Dad things. Doing big dad things.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Double yes, T sir. Definitely doing big dad things.
Yes, sir.
Definitely, definitely. But yeah, man, what your guys been up to, man? Like, shit.
Man.
What you been up to, Pat?
You know me.
He said, "You know me."
Had to take a break from the music just for a minute, you know, because I'm oversaturating myself, getting myself ear fatigue a little bit by doing this. So I'm gonna pick up the game in a little bit since I just got Mortal Kombat 1. See what that's talking about.
Yeah,
that and just working pretty much. That's it.
That's what's up. Yeah, and that ear fatigue is a thing. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? That's definitely a thing. I know I encounter that every once in a while. Creating. You know, even practicing DJing and doing mashups and stuff like that. Yeah, you definitely, any creative out there, if you're constantly, it's nothing wrong. And we want to keep at it with the work.
Yeah.
We want to, but there's nothing wrong with taking a rest or having, you know, you time, stuff like that. So you definitely want
to
do that.
And big shout out to you for, getting our media together and putting together our YouTube stuff, man. I know it take away from family time stuff like that, but you know we appreciate you out here.
Most definitely. So E, yeah, what you been up to, man?
I mean, like I said, I'm trying to get the apparel, but I want to get it right. I want to get you guys quality materials and stuff like that. So the Filmo Thick 777 coming to you real shortly. I'm just trying to get everything together. I'm still working on some art projects I'm working with. I'm trying to reach out to some other artists as well. And again, C Red and my homeboy King Rhodes. Big shout out to y'all. We're gonna get with y'all. We're gonna make something happen.
Most definitely. Most definitely. Rick, how about yourself, man? What you been up to?
Hey, bro. I'm just trying to stay out of the way. You know, as they say down here in Fayetteville, trying to stay out of the way. Just putting a few things on my plate as well. Just like everybody else, just trying to stay busy and stay a part of the culture.
Mm-hmm. That's what's up, mm-hmm. man. So, yeah, man. Now that we got that out the way, it's time. Y'all know what it's time for. It's time for some... Timeline Teens. So yeah, man. Hey, it's been all over the news, especially hip hop. Look, it's ironic because my wife and I were just talking about this, right? And we said 2023, man, it's like the year of breakups and divorces and separations and the whole nine, bro. Like it's you know, it's a lot going on in that hemisphere. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? You got your Iman Shumperts and Tiana Taylors. You got your Jeezys and Jenny Mize.
Man. Yeah.
You got your Steve Harveys.
Yeah. Well, that's kind of sampling.
You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? Like what? You got who else? I'm missing someone. I'm missing
Remy and Papoose, yeah. The kings, the god and goddess of hip hop, of bars.
So yeah, man. You know, Remy just, you know, she just had her Chrome 23 battle rap event.
Whoa.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And you know, had some pretty good cards on there, but one of the main events was Easy to Block Captain,
man,
versus Geechee Gotti.
Yeah.
So, you know, if you guys can remember,
I do.
some time back, it was at another event that mm-hmm. Remy had thrown. I think it was the one right before this one. There was, you know, some speculation and
some talk about that.
Talk about, you know, some infidelity and talks about Papoose not beating the brakes off us people and mm-hmm. you know the whole nine. You know how that went. But then after a while it died down.
It just disappeared,
yeah.
Really.
And yeah, it disappeared. And so yeah. Now it's back up in the headlines,
man.
Thanks to this Chrome 23 event.
Man.
And everybody's talking about Geechee Gotti's third round and how he was talking to Easy and to Remy.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? What say you? What say you, people?
Man, to me, I was like, Remy kept, she a strong woman, but I know it had to bother her. Like, they even had the interview at the end. I know I had to kind of get at her, like, touch her a little bit. And, like, Papoose, a man's man, you know what I'm saying? So imagine that, and then it's out in the air, you know, table leg. Somebody giving your wife table leg, you know what I'm saying? I don't know, but I don't know.
Somebody giving your wife a table leg.
Give her a table leg, baby. Boy, I don't know.
What say you, Pat?
Man, I mean, ain't much I really can say because she ain't refuted.
She ain't step out there and say anything.
And that seems to be the thing. It's, you know, a lot of folks are saying that she neither confirmed or denied. Yeah. Like, so, you know, and then there's a video that's been floating around of after the battle of them, like, face-to-face talking, mm-hmm. and it looks like he was wanting to give her a kiss or some shit.
Whoa.
And she was looking at him like, nah, nigga, nah, not right now, nigga. You
this
know
ain't
what I'm
the
saying?
Time. This ain't the
this
time.
This ain't the time or the place.
Not with them beekeeper teeth.
That's horrible.
But yeah, so... So, you know, Hip Hop DX has an article out. Says Remy Ma has been accused of cheating on her longtime husband Papoose with battle rapper Easy the Block Captain, but she's not sweating it.
Yeah.
Said according to rumors, the Bronx rapper has been creeping with Easy for some months now.
Wow.
You know what I mean? They even went on to say that blogger Tasha K,
mm-hmm.
you know, the infamous Tasha K,
mm-hmm.
she's using a photo of Easy and Remy, of them out eating, you know, wow. at like a restaurant or something like that.
I truly hope
but
that ain't so.
When I saw the pic, I mean, they didn't right away tell me like, oh, she's cheating, because like she has her own business. He happens to yeah. work for her.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Now, why it's just them two and not anybody else that's yeah. employed by her? I don't know.
I mean,
but.
Have you seen, I mean, not, that's stupid. Y'all seen what Easy the Block Captain look like, right?
I
don't know what he look like, but I mean,
look at him and Pap, though. Look, if you see him and Pap, you'll look and be like, okay, Remy definitely got a type. Like, seriously.
Yeah. I mean, yeah.
So I said, according to rumors, the Bronx rapper has been creeping with Easy for some months now, right? It says, following a battle between Easy and fellow battle rapper Geechee Gotti on Saturday, September 17th, the rumors came up again when Geechee brought up the rumored relationship.
Mm-hmm.
He said something to the effect of, I don't give a fuck if you're fucking this nigga. Just tell him to stop screwing the business. Y'all the poster child symbol for black love. Every interview he show his admiration and tell the world how he thinks this woman is the greatest. Nigga, he held you down in prison for 6 years. I know it was not nice. He cried big tears.
Mm-hmm.
mm. So he said he stood by you, by your biggest accomplishments, front row, giving you big cheers.
Yep.
Man, you got a beautiful baby girl
yeah.
who is also amazing. He'll be damned if he lose you to this bozo and embraces.
Wow, man.
Listen, he took you out to the best foods. When you ain't feeling good, he put you back in the best moods. You know, something to that effect.
Is he saying my man will bite his, bite a hole in his chest if he cough? Is this what he's talking about, his teeth? Well, oh, that's wrong. That's wrong, B.
You stupid,
bro. But damn.
But yeah.
Yeah,
so,
but did you see her face, though? You see her face? She got taken off guard by that.
And,
yeah.
And exactly. And that's where I was going yeah. with it, because even, you know, with the battle and everything, she definitely was taken aback. when Geechee was, you know, pretty much talking to her. Geechee was talking to her. But you could tell she was taken aback, but then like in some instances you could tell that like her, she was sweating it. Cause I mean, she's cut from that cloth.
Yeah.
She's a battle rapper herself. So it ain't shit that she done heard.
Yeah.
That, you know what I mean? Like she's unheard everything under the sun.
But she knows she gotta have a discussion with Papoose when she get home after that though. You know, that discussion, to be a fly on that wall when that discussion happens, it's going to be crazy.
But see, who's to say, you know, and if that's the case, who's to say if they haven't already been separated?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah, we don't know.
Geechee brought it up in the battle that, you know, he wasn't in attendance.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He wasn't even there. He wasn't even in attendance at the battle.
Well, that's because that battle was out of town.
Everything exactly. Was
New York. I forgot where they were this time, but they were at a completely different location.
I want to say it was something since,
you know, Pat was going to pull up like a pair of drawers.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. See, I would think that it was somewhere in or near Philly or near, you know, in Pennsylvania or something like that. Because Geechee mentioned the line. He said something to the effect of, you know, Pat's not here, and you chose to have the battle somewhere to where, like, if Pat came and rolled through, Easy would have the up on him or the advantage on him.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So that tells me that it was somewhere, not in New York, but somewhere close to where, you know.
Oh, so Easy from Philly.
Yeah, Easy from Phily.
Mm. Yeah.
Mm. Yeah. Oh man.
But why trying to sabotage your man like that though?
Yeah. Why would you do that? That's because it's at the end of the day, that's still the father of your child.
That's malicious. You know what I'm saying? It's all together. Yeah, that's what
it was. If that's what it is. And like
the
I
matters
said,
of not, the heart though, you know how they go.
Yeah.
And females be salty.
They don't play by rules, bro.
They get salty. They'll do it with some shit. But hey, all right.
He said, all right.
I'm gonna give my side dude the advantage.
Yeah. I think
Pat Poole really gives a damn.
Yeah. I mean, no, you can't say that though. You know, that's still we could separate from somebody, especially in the beginning. You still gonna have some. You gonna feel a certain type of way about some things. I mean,
yeah.
Put in time, and he was doing shit for her, like when she was locked down. Like,
bro, I seen a clip where Pat Poole was like just pretty much telling how he was down for her ever since she got locked up,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And how he would visit her like every day, my nigga, for like for a whole year.
Yeah.
And to the point to where like they tried to run him out of there, and you know what I mean? He
was saying like some financial things too. He's like, he was spending some bread for her whole time she was in and stuff, doing things for her, putting money on books. It's a lot that go into that.
And
visiting hours only like 2 hours.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine you going every day for 6 years and you only get to see your wife for 2 hours a day.
Well, in one instance, he did say something like to the effect of it was from like 8 to 4 or some shit. Yeah. But even still, that's like a job damn near, because you up there and then you go home, then you repeat the same shit the next day. And I'm imagining, you know, she was what, in Rikers?
Yeah.
So like that's a travel, you know what I mean? You gotta have some bread to travel, you know what I'm saying, back and forth all the time like that. But I say that to say that, you know, he's been down with her from day one.
Yeah.
And if that is the case.
Yeah, that's fucked up.
That's fucked up, man.
But we don't know all the ins and outs. We don't know Papoose's side. We don't know Remy's side. And we don't know what really.
So that's why I'm shooting Bel to Remy. Like, I'm not gonna go on the towards the allegation side that everybody else is doing right now, until there's more facts, if they do come out. What I will say is she's neither confirmed nor denied.
I mean, if so, even if she did or even if she didn't, if she does or if she doesn't, people's feelings change all the time.
Yeah.
Like, mm-hmm. We need to, like, people, you know, the whole cheating allegations, you know, whatever. I mean, some people just grow apart from each other.
People need to realize when it comes to love and relationships, you're rolling the dice. It's a gamble anyway.
Yeah.
Like, it's a gamble finding the right one. It's a gamble trying to figure out if they're going to be a great spouse. It's a gamble to see well, shit, after the third year, I don't even like being around this person. I'm gonna be, it could be as simple as that.
You can love somebody and not like them.
It could be as simple as that. And they could do the work. I mean, look at the whole thing. We just, all these allegations with Steve Harvey and his wife. Mm-hmm. They've been together for a hot minute.
He was simping as hell, too. I'm over with simping hard. Oh, you be a man in the right. Oh, man.
I don't even know why anybody even listened to that dude in the first place. That dude been married, what, three times, hell, four times? Some shit like that. Who was actually supposed to listen to Steve Harvey?
About what you
nobody
supposed
to do. With the whole Remy and Pap thing, man, I'm just taking it day by day to see what new developments come out, because like I said, it's not looking good it's trouble in paradise, man. When it comes to the relationships in 2023, man, so if you got a woman, hold on tight. If you got a man, hold on tight.
If they good people, work it out. Find a way to work it out. Because it ain't, you know what I'm saying, out here, you ain't guaranteed to find somebody as good as that person or, you know, even better. You know what I'm saying? You thinking the grass is greener on the other side of the fence.
It ain't always green. That's what I'm saying. You might wake up and that shit be brown. And you're like, wait a minute, I don't like brown grass. And then that's the end of that. And people are like, well, why did he leave? And why did he, know what I'm saying? So it's just like, You don't know what they're going through. I do like the fact, like, you know, or let me put it this way. I hope if this is the case that they take the same approach that Tiana did with Iman.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
She put out a statement to the effect of like, yo, y'all stop bashing my nigga.
Yeah.
That's my best friend still. That's the father of my damn, you know, my kids. Yeah. Like, you know what I mean?
And that's the most important thing.
What's between us, and I'm only telling y'all this because I just see y'all bashing him too much, this, that, and the third. And wasn't no infidelity, this, that, and the third. I'm just putting that out there. Once I get this out there, what'd she say? She said the group chat is closed again. And I believe in that, man. Like,
that's real.
I'm very private, even with my very own relationship. Yeah. Me and my wife, like, I'm very private. Like, I don't believe in, and this goes back to like couples that they, you know, every couple goes through some things and they have arguments.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. This goes back to couples, you know, having disagreements or arguments, and they tell, they hit social media or they tell a family.
Boy.
And you get what I'm saying?
And then y'all get back together and then you still got that other element. Feeling a certain type of way, like, you know,
exactly.
What I'm
your family looking at
reconciled.
You still, your family still looking at you as the fuck nigga, because even though y'all resolve, you and homegirl resolve, but you still the fuck nigga because
fuck nigga, the clown,
yeah,
all that,
yeah, because now it's like, oh, this nigga, oh, he treat my daughter wrong, or like, or you know, she treats my son wrong, you know what I'm saying. That's why I don't like to bring family into it. I don't, friends into it. Yeah. I don't like the shit that really gets me is the social media shit.
Mm.
When you posting on Facebook and all of that, you'll post all your good times and all that, but then you want to dog him out, dog her out during the bad times and shit.
But that goes to say too, like how private or public you have your relationship. You have a public relationship and you allow people into it, then you know. Just like they'll praise you for the good stuff, they're gonna praise you for the bad stuff.
Exactly. So,
you know what I'm saying? I mean,
that's why I
respect the bad.
Exactly. So that's why I respect Tiana Taylor for what she did.
Yeah.
So I'm
and she one of my baby mamas too. She's slim, thick with tapered ankles, Tiana. I know, disrespect to you, dude. Basketball dude. Tiana Taylor.
Basketball dude.
Hey, you basketball dude to me right now though, like what?
He's stupid. But yeah, so
Basketball dude.
Hey.
But I hope, you know, I'm hoping that Remy and Pap are taking the same approach.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? As that and keeping everything, you know, if they are separated, then that's none of my business.
It's none of my business. Because it don't take away from Remy Ma being a dope ass MC. I'm not even gonna say female MC. Shit, I'll put her above some dudes. She got bars like no other. Papoose the same way. That's why I equate them to the god and goddess of hip hop.
Oh, yeah,
when
most definitely.
Union came together, man, I was like, God damn, what are they child gonna
be? Like what Gigi said, like with the whole black love thing, like they were like the poster child for black love. Like that, they were. They actually, it's actually.
Definitely were.
I don't know if you guys know, remember that show that came on, it came on the OWN channel. It was called, the name of the show was called Black Love. My wife and I watched it.
Yeah.
My wife and I watched it like wholeheartedly, like anytime it came on, and they were on it.
Yeah.
Talking about their story and their black love and stuff. And they have a story.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they were, you know, giving their little testimony on the show and everything. And that inspired a lot of couples.
It did.
It did.
So I get the outrage from the fans, like, yo, oh man, we looked up to you. You know what I'm saying? Oh. But
We're human.
We're humans. Everybody goes through some shit. But my only thing is, I would like to think that they, you know, this
work it out.
Of course, we want them to work it out. But I'm saying, even if it doesn't get to that point, their business is their business.
Keep it private.
I fell in love with them being in love. I fell in love with their relationship. Like,
keep it private.
Pause on, like, I ain't trying. But I fell in love with them. Like they union, that shit was like it, and it didn't seem like it was a gimmick.
It wasn't
gimmicky or nothing like that. It was real.
It was definitely real. Definitely real. But I just hope they keep that shit on the private level, and you know, and keep it pushing. Like I said, we'll find out more details if there's any details to be had. You know, but you know who else keeps their relationship private and extra private,
crazily private too.
Chris Evans, Captain America himself. Mm-hmm. So, you know, around September 9th, I believe, Chris Evans and his now wife, Alba Baptista, they had a private ceremony.
Mm-hmm.
NDAs were signed.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It don't get no more private than that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You know, he's been dating this woman for like, maybe I want to say like 2 years, a year and a half to 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
And she's on the young side. You know what I mean? Yeah. You know, he's on the young side. I mean, well, she's on the young side. You know, Chris Evans is like four.
Yeah, she's not chill though, too. I seen her. Chris
Evans is my age, you know, 42.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And she's 26. So. Mm. What do you got to say? What you got to say?
It's crazy because
Rick, you have anything to contest to that?
Hey,
he's over there breathing hard, like
I'm not. It's not a bad thing. It's just I feel it because that's the ticks that be hollering at me, like around that age range, and I'll be like, damn, I got a daughter close to you. You know what I'm saying? I got babies. You know what I'm saying?
That's the chicks that be hollering at me.
Man, I'll be like. And I'll be trying to not. I'll be trying to be like, no, you know, you somebody's daughter. All women is somebody's daughter.
Yeah.
But I'm like, hey, you know, hey. But yeah.
So
congratulations, B.
So yeah, they had a intimate, you know, little private ceremony in Cape Cod. Cape Cod, it just sounds so beautiful, you know?
Yeah.
Cape Cod. Where was your wedding? Cape Cod.
Oh, yeah, that's nice.
Of all places. But yeah, so, you know, they've been, like I said, they've been dating for like a year to 2 years or whatever. And then, you know, he's been living his best life though. Like, cause he's even to the point to where he's like, I'm good with coming back to the movies. Like, I don't know about y'all, man. Like, y'all done Captain America meet out.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Yeah, Captain America, me out.
But that's
look how long ago the first Captain America came out.
But that's been him throughout his acting career, though. Like, what was the movie where he was he played on the football team I'm on the football team. It was with the stick. Was the one with the stick where they throw the ball back and forth or like
lacrosse.
Yeah, he was like on a cross, I believe, or a football team. And he was messing with the girl who is like, she didn't come from quite the rich family, but she was like kind of quirky, but she was kind of cute.
Younger than Chris Evans, right?
Yeah. Okay. So like,
I'm lost.
He was always the good guy.
Oh yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He always played that. He always had
image,
that good guy image.
Yeah.
And I respect it because it was borderline corny you know what I'm saying, like corny or, you know, like to be expected because of his look. But he was always, he was still so cool. It was like, ah, right, yeah, I'm going to let him ride with that.
Right. Yeah. Right. Yeah. He, you know, like you say, he has that hero look.
Yeah.
Good guy look. And, you know, he's been in plenty of movies.
I'm seeing that.
Yeah, yeah.
He's been in tons of movies.
Street Kings.
But
yep, he was the cop in Street Kings. He was still being good hearted there. He was trying to, you know, tote the line, even though, you know, they was going, you know, Keanu Reeves was like straight savage in that movie.
That's right.
Snowpiercer was good too.
Yeah. But yeah, like, you know, he's been living his best life, enjoying himself. Yeah. You know. He's like, yo, he said, now I'm going to enjoy my wife. I'm enjoying family, you know? Yeah. But
kudos to my man.
Yeah, most definitely. Oh, so a few Marvel actors.
In attendance.
Yeah. In attendance.
Of course, Robert Downey Jr.
Yep, yeah. Robert Downey Jr., Iron Man himself, of course.
With his wife.
Yeah, with his wife. Jeremy Renner. No.
Chris Hemsworth.
Chris Hemsworth, yep. But yeah, like I said, the whole thing.
Yeah, it was good. Jeremy Renner up and around, considering his accident he just had.
Oh yeah, most definitely. Yeah. Most definitely. Damn, I forgot about that.
I thought it was gonna be a wrap the way they was talking at one time.
He wasn't gonna make it at all.
Yeah. I remember that too. I was like, whoa! I didn't know it was that severe.
Yeah, it was serious.
Yeah, I didn't know it was that severe.
I was trying to figure out, I'm like, how the hell you get ran over by a snowplow? What in the hell was you doing?
What were you
doing?
Yeah, that now, that's wild. That's wild. You know what I'm saying? So, but yeah, man, you know, much respect goes out to Chris and his wife. And yeah, I mean, it's good to see some type of hope in the year 2023, because like I said, there's a lot of breakups and divorce and you know, splits and divorces, and you know, and here's a prime example of love prevailing. Yeah. And in 2023, we'll see what they looking like in a few years.
Time will tell. I hope the best for them.
I think one of the biggest things is honestly trying to have a relationship in Hollywood.
Yeah, that's
crazy. Know, much like hip hop, it's hard to have a relationship, especially when both of y'all are doing the same thing. When both of y'all are MCs or both of y'all are actors,
and then you have to be in different places for different events. Yeah, you got to be in different places, different events and stuff, and you're gonna see, like, people act like you can't see somebody else and appreciate their beauty, or, you know what I'm saying, be attracted to that person. But is the true thing within you is if you say, okay, I got something just as great at home, and you got to remember that, I believe. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, most definitely. I mean, it's you know, like we were saying earlier, as far as marriage, you know, once again, in order to keep that union tight.
Yeah.
Don't let everybody in your business, man. Like,
please don't.
It just boils down to that. Don't let everybody into your business.
And that's exactly
once
what
you
happens.
Do, it is doomed.
Yeah, and you listen to mama and daddy, and then mama and daddy don't pay bills in your household. You know what I'm saying? Mama and daddy don't. You know what I'm saying? You respect your mom and dad's opinion, but everything going in your household don't need to go to your mom and daddy, best friends and stuff like that. Because sometimes, I know with the female, it could be with males too, the female waiting for you to drop the ball so she can get your nigga. So you telling her all the bad shit, and she liking your dude, or he liking your, vice versa, and then they waiting for the sabotage to come in so they can creep in, so... Mm-hmm. You gotta be careful with that.
Exactly.
It gets like that. It gets like that. Yep. So... But yeah, man. Speaking of another relationship, let's talk about Drake and his album.
Drizzy. Hey, y'all. Hey, so before this, they was clowning me because they was saying that I give Drake his Tribe Dude. I said, he in the hunted. He ain't outside no more. He in the hunted.
He
in the top 100.
He said he's in his top. You hear this, Rick? He said Drake is in his top 100.
100.
Which means he's 99. He said the nigga just got
here. I ain't say he was 99.
He said he's 100.
I ain't say he 99.
Oh, shit.
He said he's 100.
You said that nigga was 101?
But okay, I'm going to clear it up.
Look, it's ironic that his album is called For All the Dogs. And this nigga was the 101st Dalmatian, nigga.
Oh, yeah, he was.
He was the 101st Dalmatian.
Now, I like Drake, though. I like Drake. I like his music. I two-step to it. But as far as him being MC, I don't see him in that light. And that's just my opinion. Nothing to take away from him.
You better tell the people, hey.
He is the Michael Jackson of y'all era.
Hold on.
Young boys, he's the Michael Jackson of y'all era.
Hold on. Before we go any further.
Okay, go ahead.
The views of E. Ray.
Bill Mo Thick, baby. Bill Mo Thick. Is only mine. It's not. Don't put it on them.
The views.
I got big shoulders.
Of E. Ray. Are not the views of Hip Hop Marvels Podcast.
Nah, not at all.
Mm-mm.
Hey, listen.
Nah, we keep it going.
Great guy. Great. He made great music with his consortium of writers and beatmakers.
Man,
great musician.
Come on, man.
Even Mike had writers. You know
what, honestly, I could dig Drake when he was hungry. There's some stuff I heard him on. He was hungry, like the joints he did with Little Brother, the joints he did with Elzai. He was hungry then. He wanted to be an MC. He wanted to be considered one of the best. But after that, dude started making a little bit of money and
Kiki
had some women holler at him and stuff like that. Why it was kind of like.
I'm sorry, Rick Rule. Hey, blood, I'm with you, Rick Rule. I'm ad libbing for you. I'm ad libbing for you.
Sorry, Drake, but I hated that damn song. I really hated that.
Hey, but look, y'all mad. I mean, y'all think y'all, hey, he ain't mad because he getting draws, panties storm. Hey, look, this dude laughing at the bank. I don't think this dude is one iota worrying about. Film on thick.
What we think.
Yeah.
For real.
He ain't worrying about film on thick. Because that nigga bank count looking better than mine right now. Play one.
Shit. Better than all ours put together. The hell you
I'm not going to say that he cares about us, but Drake definitely wants the respect of his peers that's in the game. He definitely wants that.
He doesn't want to
be looked at as whacked by, say, a Razzcast or an exhibit or anything like that. He definitely wants the respect and admiration of his peers. That definitely irks him. He doesn't care about us. No, of course not. But he definitely wants the respect of his peers.
His work ethic is crazy, though. I give him his work ethic. Yeah. It's phenomenal.
Yeah, nothing to take away from any of those other objects. But like I said, like think about it. If you heard somebody wrote Ain't no love in the city for Jay.
Why would don't go there.
Hey, if somebody wrote that, if somebody even wrote like half a bar, like, you know, Jay said that. It's just he said for the rest of y'all niggas, y'all get half a bar. Fuck y'all niggas. Think about it. If somebody wrote that for Jay, would y'all be upset, or would y'all have to feel a certain type of way a little bit?
Not with Jay coming in the way he came in.
I don't mind. Matter.
He was already.
We talked about this before.
Driven.
Right. And we talked about this before. I don't mind if that's what Drake chooses to do and he chooses to have writers, so be it. He's not out here claiming he's a super duper lyricist.
But if you getting in your feelings because you're not getting respect from them type of MCs like Rick was talking about, then that is a problem for him. He does have a problem with it.
No, not really. He just because he can choose to do more of that type of content.
Or he can chooses just, not if to. If he dedicate an album.
He can still be.
I gotta see it.
See, it's a different. It's different if all he did was the singing shit. You know what I'm saying? It's different. If that's all he did. Like, he didn't do any rapping. But the fact that he does rap and he's good at rapping, and on top of that, doesn't.
If somebody writing his bars.
Self-proclaim that he's this almighty, super lyrical dude. Then writing is, you know what I'm saying?
But
he hasn't even been really honestly confirmed that you know.
Right, that's what I'm saying.
That people are writing for
well,
him.
Well, I know
like
he's
that.
I know he's collaborated.
He had.
But he also wrote shit himself.
Yeah.
So, to be honest. Let me ask you this. Ja Rule or Drake? Who would you put first?
And what I mean, what's the
Ja Rule? It don't matter, Ja Rule or Drake, because I'm hearing from a lot of old heads that Ja Rule was the first Drake. If you think about it, that make a lot of sense. He was the first one that was doing the singing. What I think about you, even though he had the Cookie Monster voice, I hear a lot of people, influential MCs, saying that he was the first Drake. I've recently heard that. So who would you put?
Then Drake? 50 bodies them and then use the damn style.
But what I'm saying, who would you put first, Drake or
as far as the sing songy rap shit? I mean, yeah, Ja Rule was doing that shit, but
no, who would you put first?
Drake.
You'll put Drake over Ja Rule?
Yeah, Drake over
because
Ja Rule.
Because he took that shit to the stratosphere, bro.
I'll do it real quick.
Yeah, okay. He took it to the stratosphere. But, sometimes, look, sometimes.
Yeah, I gotta say Drake.
Yeah,
too.
Sometimes first ain't. It all the time, bro. But, it really, but if that was the deal, Kool Herc could be better than, I mean, not Kool Herc, Melly Mel would be better than Drake right now. If first was the, you know what I'm saying?
I'm not saying like that. I'm equating it to like they both singing, they both were doing the singing to the women type of thing,
Drake
taking the shirt off.
Drake does
but,
that.
Yeah, Drake, but with the bars, though, like barred up.
Drake
got him barred up.
Drake got some bars. Drake got bars. Nigga,
but
like,
you know what? Who I would put first overall over both of them is Fonte.
Oh, yeah. Oh, hell yeah.
And look,
Fonte been singing for a little bit now, too.
Yeah, mm-hmm. He has.
Right, we done went all the way on a tangent.
I'm sorry. They know my two guys who I had to speak out for because it's a lot of people who can't speak. It's a lot of people who can't speak on Drake. It's a lot of people who can't speak on Eminem that want to say something, but they can't say it because it'll mess with their numbers. So I'm speaking for them. I'm speaking for them, Playboy. I'm with you.
Oh, my goodness. So basically, all right. So, you know, Drake, he pushed his album back. You know what I'm saying? We were all expecting the album, actually, midnight. Around midnight.
I thought it was supposed to drop the 19th.
No, it was supposed to drop the 22nd.
Kiki.
You the one who told me he had the barrettes and stuff in his head. Kiki. That
oh,
said
no,
922.
Dropped the 19th, my bad.
Right.
Hey,
right.
Why did he do that?
But
Go ahead, bud. I'm sorry.
So, you know, his album was slated for September 22nd. It is now the 21st. We are recording on the 21st. And it was supposed to drop. We were supposed to have that shit in our Spotify or whatever the case, you know, whatever we listen to around midnight. But the plans changed, bro.
Yeah.
Plans changed. So
I was looking forward to that.
Yeah, so they're saying September 16th. What?
Maybe that Magic 3 kind of shook him a little bit.
I don't think that shook him at all, to be honest.
That Magic 3, baby. Hey, that Magic 3.
Magic
hey,
3.
Nas, I love you for that. Like, 2, Magic 2, it was maybe not. But 3, I love
demographic
it.
Of listening.
Real.
You got
I don't
me,
think
Nas.
He was phased at all by Magic 3. Nah.
Hey, Magic 3, though, that's my shit. I was bumping it. I was driving.
See, this is how much of a... This is how much of a...
I love it.
A Drake... hater he is. Like, he don't want us talking about Drake. He's gonna throw Nas in the mix. You see that shit?
Nas, God MC. And you number 2 on my list of all time.
He's gonna
behind
throw,
Big, and that's Big.
He's gonna throw Nas in the mix. We in the middle.
Big your number 1?
Big my number 1 all day, baby.
Okay.
Boy. Big number 1.
Who's your number 100?
My number 100? Kiki, are you with me? You love me? Barrett and a heart in my motherfucking park.
This dude is
you're saying Big. I'm like,
Oh, okay. Hey, that's listen.
Hold on. Let's bring this back.
Bring it back. Because I'm a savage.
For real. Because y'all talking about Big, and we about to go in another direction.
A whole
nother direction.
I'm sorry, Dub. I'm ignorant a little bit.
So basically, just let me get through this. Just let me get through Drake. Pause. Goodness.
Pause. Gracious.
But so yeah, you know, it said Saturday, September 16th, Drake posted an update about his project in an Instagram story. He said, okay, my dilemma I'm faced with is either cancel shows to finish the album, or I complete the mission and drop the album before the last show. I owe you all these memories we are building, and anywhere we have missed to date, we will be spinning back for sure. So, I mean,
I can respect it.
I can respect that.
Yeah. I can respect that.
He trying to get the fans everything they asking for, bro. And if the fans got an issue with that,
I mean,
you can't please everybody.
As a creator, you want to be really serious about your craft. I mean, because myself, I re-listen to everything like that I put together. I'm listening to the hi-hats. I'm listening to the rim shots. I'm listening to the bells. Exactly. I'm listening to this. Is this level mix right? Does this have the right effect on it? I understand it.
Your worst critic.
So I can respect. Really be my own worst critic, but I understand what you. I can respect it,
and I respect him. I talk a lot of shit about Drake, but I respect that aspect that he want to give you the best. He want to give you the best quality.
Exactly.
That's why he number one.
Yeah.
Pop artist. Let me stop playing. Go
Bruh.
Ahead. Go. I'm sorry.
He think this show called hip. Pop Marvels, nigga. Hip pop Marvels, nigga.
Nah, he good though.
But yeah, so you know, he went on to put at the end of the post, you know, he wrote for all the dogs, October 6th. Mm. It's only right.
Mm.
Yeah. So okay. Which, you know, October is his month.
October's very own.
October's very own. The 6th.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. What do y'all think about that? I mean, I'm kind of anticipating this Drake album because, the last few albums haven't been like solely.
He was experimenting.
Yeah, he was experimenting with a lot of shit.
I know one of the albums they said it didn't do well like he thought it would. Then he did that other last album he did, and it did a lot better.
Well, see, that was the 21 album he did with 21. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Get back to 40. You
know, yeah.
Get back to Noah.
Right.
Get back to that man producing.
Yeah, exactly.
Please.
Exactly.
Because that combo there, Drake and 40, crazy.
Yeah. Okay. So I'm excited, man.
Drake knows when Drake was at the top, and just in my opinion, Drake was at the top. But then when those experimental moments came along, that's how Kendrick passed him. Yeah. That's how J. Cole passed him. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? You can't slack up. You got to stick to what works for you, not just necessarily try to go for album sales, which is what he did a couple times. I'm trying to make records that's going to be on the radio and that's going to sell.
Yeah.
Where I think Kendrick and J. Cole were themselves and they were still putting up numbers.
Yeah.
Exactly. I think that's what he's going back to towards though with this album. I honestly think that's what he's trying to go for.
I give J. Cole kind of like the Nas of their generation. He like the Nas of this generation right now, J. Cole. I'll give like Kendrick more of the Pac of this generation. If that makes sense to anybody, I don't know.
It's subjective. Like you can switch those around and shit.
Yeah.
It's
Kendrick's pretty, not as aggressive as Pac was. Pac was, in your face.
Kendrick reminds me more of Andre. More of Andre 2000.
Yeah. Yeah,
but yeah. So you know, we'll be looking forward to Drake's album. For all the dogs, he got his single is out now with SZA.
Yeah,
what's the name of the single? It's called
Slime You Out.
Slime You Out. Oh, speaking of,
we're gonna talk about the Halle Berry.
Yeah, yeah. Speaking of, so
Halle Berry.
So so, you know, the artwork for Slime You Out, right? You know, he put the image on his Instagram, and it was an image of Halle Berry from one of the like Nickelodeon Kids Choice Awards or whatever, where she got slimed. He put it up, and Halle Berry wasn't too too pleased with that, man. She was, you know, she told, basically, I guess he asked her.
He did.
Yeah, he asked her to use it. And I'm believing he was going to use it for the original artwork. Because the artwork has changed for that single.
Yeah.
It's different. But I'm assuming he asked her to use that. And she was like, nope.
But what is the
and he still put it up on
what's the Instagram. Content of the song though? Do you
the
know?
Name of the song is called Slime You Out.
But what is the content behind it? Like what is he saying?
It does ain't anybody, got nothing anybody... to do with Kids' Choice Award.
I don't know because I never heard the song.
Oh, definitely got nothing
so
to do with
it. So is he talking about like all skeet skeet?
Let me
skeet?
Slime you out.
Let me slime you out. Whatever you think that slime you out means.
Well, I can see why she probably wouldn't have wanted that to happen.
But
like that.
It ain't got nothing. But I mean it's
look what it does for her though, just him doing that.
It's a public image. But some people don't.
Yeah,
believe, you know,
like there are a lot of people that already put her through the.
She's from the old school.
Yeah,
she's from the old school.
Hey,
and then you know she got to pay.
You know what I'm saying? Like
she got to pay child support and alimony to the dude she just divorced.
That's what I'm saying.
So like she probably like
that could have for her. That could have helped her with that.
She got
to do assume and you know get the first couple of checks out the way.
But some people value their image more than money.
Yeah,
you got people that do. You know,
yeah, because she got kids, man. Regardless, she a mother. You know what I'm saying? She a sister. She slim. She was the original, one of the original slim thicks with tapered ankles. Baby mamas. Yeah, hey, y'all can't mess with my boo, Holly Berry.
So
as long as the internet's alive, kids are gonna find their parents old stuff. Like I'm just waiting to see where Kim Kardashian's kids start finding shit and Kanye West's kids start finding shit. It's gonna be on.
Yeah, just like
they're gonna need therapy.
Yeah, I was just about to say that.
Just like that Freaknik thing. Them women, them doctors and lawyers. Now they professional. And they like, nah, let's not release that because we was doing. They was popping it, showing it. Is that a baby?
all the aunties be put on Front Street.
Yep.
But yeah, so you know, Halle Berry, she responded. She was mad. She was like, you know, sometimes you have to be the bigger guy, even if you're a woman. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And you know, I don't care what Drake is. He's at a point where it could have just been black. Like, you know what I mean?
Nothing special.
Yeah. He could have put anything. This dude, I mean, look, the dude put emojis of pregnant women for one of his albums. Like, he could put anything. Like, and it is.
But look what we doing right now. What are we doing?
You use for the scissor joint. That image you use, you could have used something like that and would have been good.
Oh, you talking about for the remix I did? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, anything.
But look what it's got us doing. What are we doing? We talking about the album cover.
Yeah, we're talking about it.
So now you got to go listen to it and see the content behind it. Because now, and you know, I'm the Drake hater. I'm the number one Drake hater, but I got to go back and listen to it now. And see what he's doing on my baby mama, Halle Berry. Because you're going to have to see me, Drake.
But
he don't even reference her in the song.
No.
That's what I was thinking. It doesn't say anything about her.
She's not even referenced. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, there's that. So I woke up this morning and one of my favorite. It's two shows that I watch. Mm-hmm. Two shows that I like to watch. Reruns of, you know. One is Martin.
Mm-hmm.
The other one is Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
Wow.
You know, and this year they're celebrating the 33rd anniversary of the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
Uncle Phil.
Rick, I'm going to ask you this question, man. It's the 33rd anniversary of the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. What does that show mean to you? Do you remember when you first seen it? Were you there, the premiere? Like when it premiered on... What was it, NBC?
When I was there for the first episode, I wasn't sure if the Fresh Prince was going to make it. Because I'm sitting there and I'm looking at him. I'm like, don't nobody dress like that from Philly. Neon green and blue. So wasn't nobody dressing like that from Philly. So I'm like, okay, this dude is going to be whack. Because I thought it was going to be silly and not really. And it did change because at first it was silly.
But we was dressing like that in the West Coast. So I'm going to let you know. They was dressing like that. Bermuda shorts and the hats. They was dressing like that. I used to get clowned for wearing Bermuda shorts and stuff. But
Bermuda shorts.
Go ahead. No, serious, real talk.
I didn't think the show would make it, but it definitely did like a 360 turn, probably like the second season and things like that. And it turned out to be a really good show. Will Smith trying to be a better actor than I thought he was going to be. But I definitely didn't have high hopes for it in the beginning. I thought it was going to be like maybe 1 or 2 year run, flash in the pan, and he's out of here. But the show definitely improved. They dealt with some serious subjects.
Yeah, they did.
Which is what I wanted from the beginning. I definitely wanted them to be a little bit more real.
Yeah.
As far as the content and the things that you learn on the show and about the people on the show.
Right.
The stuff with what I call the real Aunt Viv kind of went left.
Yeah.
After a while. Because I wasn't feeling Daphne Maxwell Reed at all at Aunt Viv. Yeah. I'm like, oh, this woman just gets on my nerves. But the show turned out to be better than I thought. And I ended up liking the show, and I was like a faithful watcher. I think it came on Monday, Tuesday nights, all the time back in the day. So I will definitely, the Fresh Prince is a show, and always, as always, when you represent hip hop positively, I'm always going to, stand up for the show.
Right. I think the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air matched Will Smith's rap persona like perfectly. Because back during that time, Will Smith was he was the parents just don't understand cat. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like he was the when you looked at his videos had a lot of those vibrant colors. I know you say that, folks from Philly wasn't dressing like that.
Yeah.
But I think it was a call from the production people.
It was like, if you look at it, though, not to cut you off, like remember Saved by the Bell, all that? That was that time.
Yeah.
That, you had that wacky color
screen. Yeah, the 80s and stuff. Like they were trying to showcase that. Was like that.
Yeah.
I think it helped, though, because it helps put a...
bridge the gap.
Not that too, but it helps put a pin in the the location in our minds of what the 80s was like. Get what I'm saying? Like,
and then
when you see that, it's like, okay, yeah, that was definitely in the 80s. You puffing on some good shit, ain't you, Rick?
Huh?
I said, huh? I said, you puffing on some good shit, ain't you?
Nah, I'm chilling, bro. I'm not using anything recreational at this moment.
sounded like it. I'm trying
to focus on the show. Yeah. And let's be clear too, that it wasn't an 80s show. That was the 90s.
Yeah,
it wasn't
the 90s.
Yeah. It was the 90s.
It was the 90s with Fresh Prince.
I will tell you, there were some outfits that I can definitely look at. Like, I seen him wearing a used set. I seen him wearing damaged jumpers. Now, I can't tell you at that time frame, that was being worn in Philly.
Yeah, I was like,
especially
early
in 90s. Southwest Philly.
Wait a minute. So, correct me if I'm wrong. So, the Fresh Prince started out in the early 90s, or did it start out in the 80s, though?
Like, I'm it sure, started
I,
out like 90s.
I thought it was the end of the 80s.
I would say it started in 1990 or 91. Yeah.
So it was like
90.
Okay.
So directly. That was like the turn.
The
like,
turn. You know okay. So I mean, it was close enough to it.
Because I left the Bay Area and went to Mississippi in 91, the summer of 91. So I remember seeing Fresh Prince and then there.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm just being honest because we weren't rocking that. We were dressing like steady being them, cool seeing them. We weren't dressing like Will Smith.
But I'm from my point of view, that was a Cali style. Yeah, do you think too he was in Southern Cal near the beach and stuff?
Yeah, exactly. That was more of a California thing.
Do you think that was more of a like him dressing that way was more of the influence that of the
Cali
area he was at?
Yeah,
okay.
Cali.
So it really wasn't like he came from Philly with that shit on. He was just like, I'm out here. So I'm gonna rock this shit while I'm out.
Because if you remember one of the original shows, he was wearing, I guess, kind of a Philly attire. And then as the show would grow, he would go back to the Cali style or what they was rocking in Cali or whatever at the time.
Right, right.
And then another thing I want to add is, like, everybody black experience ain't the same. Like, we got a hood adjacent cats. We got cats that come from the suburbs and everything like that. And that's something that needs to be spoke on. Like, it's a dude who do cosplay, and he do, like, He-Man, and what's his other dude he do? I think he do Spawn or Black Panther. I can't think of his name right now. I'll figure it out. I'll tell you. But he was crying, and he got a big following. He do a lot of cosplays and stuff like that. And he was saying that he saw his son. He'd be bringing his son in, and his son was playing with these two other black boys, and they was all dressed up in comics and stuff like that. And that wasn't really cool, you know what I'm saying, to be like that. You know what I'm saying? To be like, to be all cosplayed up and playing and stuff like that, you know, even though we did it in our community.
Right.
But it wasn't like, you know, everybody was on, you know, NWA and then were coming out, so you had to kind of grow up faster. So everybody... Fresh Prince, that's why I say it bridged the gap, because it showed, like, he came from, like, a rough neighborhood. He went to an upper scale black, you know, predominantly wealthy, you know, family and stuff, his cousins and stuff. So everybody, it gave a dynamic of people integrating into these two different dynamics, I would say.
Yeah, most definitely. Yeah, man. And you, with the show, you grew to love these characters.
Yeah.
Everybody from Uncle Phil, Carlton, Ashley, Hillary, Jazz, Jeffrey. Yeah,
Jeff.
Like, you know, you've grown to love Aunt Viv, you know,
I'm Team Chocolate, Aunt Viv. I'm Team Chocolate.
Nikki, Nikki. You know what I'm saying?
That storyline was whack. Now, that's when I started. That's when the first Prince started turning me off.
What didn't the Nikki storyline? Like,
why y'all got this big head child on here? I'm like, it didn't work. It didn't work. I know they tried to inject some more stuff into it, but
for
the Nikki storyline just didn't work for me.
Yeah.
For me, when it's like, for me, during that time, it's like when I was watching it during that time, it's like they came up with him out of nowhere. And I'm like, I'm watching it one day and I'm like,
yeah,
where Buckwheat come from? Like, what the fuck? Like, they got Buckwheat from the little
bastards.
Like, what the fuck?
Yeah, they made him grow up real fast. They show him Vivian pregnant, then they made him, like, grow up real fast. Like, he aged, like, in one season, he aged like six or seven. Like, what
I'm
the
like,
hell?
Yo, where's this kid? Like, who the hell? Where
superhuman.
He right. I'm like, what the hell?
He was an X-Man baby.
We're talking about the new new Fresh Prince.
Yeah, I was getting ready to go there. So
I really haven't dived into it too much. Man. I saw little snippets of it, but I haven't really looked into it.
So
I think the storylines in the new Fresh Prince are definitely better.
Better. The new Fresh Prince, it was based on Morgan Cooper's. You know, he had like a Morgan Cooper had I think it came out in like 2019. He had a viral video
on YouTube
where it was just called. I think it was just called Bel-Air.
Yeah.
Just like the show, and I remember seeing it. I was like, yo, what is it? It was like a fan made shit.
Yeah.
And I remember watching that shit. Yeah. I'm like, yo, this look hard.
Yeah.
Serious. I was like, they need to do this.
Mm-hmm.
And then fast forward, I hear inklings of like, yeah, Will Smith met up with the dude and they're pitching the show, you know, and this, that, and the third. And next thing you know, it's on Peacock or whatever.
And that's love, though, too, man. That's what hip-hop, that's what 50 years of hip-hop is. Like, because it grew up, and you know what I'm saying? It's a different era. It's a different youth feeling, whatever. Like even how my man Rick was talking about, like, Cats in Philly wasn't rocking like that or this, that.
Right.
But, like, that show now is reintroduced to a whole nother audience, and they get to see it in the light and how they see and reflect life.
Definitely.
And Will Smith, to give that dude the opportunity after seeing that, much love to Will Smith. Always been a Will Smith fan.
Yeah, I mean, and that show, it resonated culturally. Like, there's a lot of things that spun off and sprung off from that show.
Man.
You know, culturally. They got the Fresh Prince Jordans. Which ones were they? The fives, right?
Mm-hmm.
They're the fives, with no laces.
Yeah, with no laces. Like, the Fresh Prince Jordan fives. They got, you know, it's just a whole bunch of things. You know, you got, you know, different MCs doing references to Fresh Prince. Mm-hmm. Yeah. They just didn't they do like an Airbnb with the mansion?
Yeah.
Like not too long ago.
Yeah,
you could stay in the mansion and like an Airbnb. You could stay in the Bel-Air mansion and shit. You could stay. Yeah.
I'll be up and down that staircase.
Yeah, you know, the handshake that him and Jack that Will and Jazz did. You know, the little psh. you know, everything from that or just a waiting for Jazz to get thrown out the door. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You know it's about to go down.
It was definitely culturally relevant.
Yeah, oh yeah, most definitely.
Time, like you said, the timeline, like you put a time and culturally relevant, and it was a good thing. It was like our Cosby, it was like a newer Cosby show for a newer generation as well at that time.
Right. And the theme song, let's not forget that. Yeah. That's everybody. It's like everybody knows.
West Philadelphia, born and raised.
Everybody knows that yeah. theme song. You know what I'm saying? So, but yeah, it's just good to, I mean, it's amazing that we're talking about the 33rd anniversary. Like,
damn, time
flies. And time does fly. And it's like, it seems like yesterday I was just sitting on the floor of my grandmother's living room watching this shit.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? Uh-huh. So, yeah, you know what I mean? Big shout out to everyone involved with the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. One of my favorite episodes was the behind the scenes episode that they did when they were showing Will and Carlton or whatever. They were going through the lot where they were recorded at and they filmed. They were showing all the outtakes and shit.
Mm-hmm. I think I remember that one.
That was one of my favorite episodes. What's one of your favorite episodes? I do like the one when they went to the Oprah show and Carlton was behind stage and the music came on and Carlton was getting it. and when him and Will were on stage, you know, doing the Apache shit. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, those are a few of my favorite episodes, man. What are some of your
The one where him and Carlton were locked up.
Oh shit.
Yeah, Uncle real. Phil came up in there. Like, bruh.
Yeah.
That really, like,
yeah.
I was like, yeah, digging his ass.
Right.
Let him know what it is.
I had a couple of them. One with Tisha Campbell and he was trying to get married. Tisha Campbell, they got locked in that closet. She started pulling off her nails.
During the earthquake?
Yeah.
The earthquake.
Lee press on.
And then the one with him and Nia Long was like, they had the little the pool house and they was rocking in the pool house together.
Right.
Yeah, because, you know, Nia Long.
We got to speak to that. This dude had the illest role gallery of women on a single show, bro. Mm-hmm.
What's her name? The America's Top Model. He had her too. Yeah. Banks. Yes.
Vivica Fox. Jasmine Guy. I'm forgetting somebody.
Who am I forgetting? Noodles.
He had a lot. Like that Rose Gallery.
Was Jada on there?
Jada?
Was she on there one time?
Did she play on there?
Was Jada on there?
I'm not sure. No. You had to look that up, like the women on Fresh Prince, because he had them. Yeah. He had a lot of them.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Big Willie.
Yeah. So that was definitely, That was definitely a milestone, like to have that many women.
Stacey Dash,
I remember Stacey that Dash. Episode. Yeah.
Wow. I don't even remember Stacey Dash being on that. I don't remember not saying that she wasn't. I don't remember seeing it. But I had to see it. And like I said, that was like something that I used to, you know, when things come on TV, you know, your butt is inside the house from like 8 to like 11.
Yeah.
But that was us, though. You
watching stuff on TV.
We knew what time. Hey, you weren't going to have a black crime to happen when In Living Color came on. What was it? Thursday nights? Thursday, 8 o'clock?
That was Sunday night.
Well, Sunday night, yeah.
Sunday nights.
You wouldn't have no black crime at that day because everybody's in their butt. When Martin came on, everybody their butt was at home. You know what I'm saying? We had, even like, what was that? TGIF. When they had what's that with Urkel and them, Family Matters and all that.
Family Matters.
Yeah.
Elise Neal. Damn. He had Elise Neal on there.
Noodles, baby.
She was on there too. Wow.
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah, man. He made me try one of his lines in high school, man.
Which one was it?
Said, man, you make me want to plant you and grow a whole field of y'all.
Oh, God damn. I remember what he was saying. He said, damn, girl, what you doing? He said something about you've been running through my mind all night, all day. I was like, yeah.
Yeah, man. So, yeah, man, big shout out to everybody involved, man.
Yeah, them isms. Bel-Air,
one of the dopest shows on television. Yep. You know, so.
Thank you, Will Smith, for giving us that, man, and blessing our community
and
showing us that we can do everything. You know what I'm saying?
Speaking of women up here, Garcelle Bouvier.
Oh, Garcelle. Look, go ahead, read the list. Read the list.
Vanessa Williams.
Read the list.
Amy Hunter.
Okay, read the list.
Victoria Rowell.
Wow. Oh, Victoria. You talking about, you don't know who Victoria Rowell is from? Young and the Restless, my
guy? I know from Young and the Restless, right?
Yeah. Oh.
I know you're talking.
Mari Morrow.
Oh,
wow.
Of course, Queen Latifah.
I remember Mari Morrow from How to Be a Player.
Yeah.
That's what I remember.
Yeah, buddy.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, what happened exactly to her? Because she was.
I don't know. It's a few of them that fell off the map, but we're going to have to say that for another show.
She was my mama.
I said he had women like the women that was on Different World back in the day.
Yeah.
Yep, Different World, for real. You know what I'm saying?
Pam Grier.
Oh, yeah, I remember that. She was one of the daughters. Oh. He was messing with one of their daughter, her daughters or something.
Wow. Yeah.
I remember that episode.
But yeah, man, so, you know, we're going to keep it moving. And like you said last time, E, you know, we were talking about, you had mentioned Werewolf by Night.
Mm.
When we were talking about the shows
that
and
was
all,
ill,
of,
man.
All of the strikes and everything. So, you know, Marvel Direct, they put out an article, says Marvel Studios announces historic re-release of one beloved Disney Plus project.
Yeah.
So when I seen that headline, I was like, what are they about to do? You know what I'm saying? You know, so
we have Halloween coming up next this month too.
Yeah.
In October.
Yeah, buddy. So it
favorite
says
holiday.
So it says one of the MCU's most highly regarded Disney Plus projects is set for a historic re-release, bringing it back to fans in a whole new light. Gail Garcia Bernal's take on Jack Russell, Werewolf by Night, came to life in late 2022 in his own Marvel Studios special presentation. Remember, like I told you, like the little one-shot special presentation thing?
Yeah.
It says, the special instantly became one of the most beloved projects in MCU history. With glowing critic reviews.
I loved it.
But particularly for his use of black and white footage and practical elements that took viewers back to the days of classic horror films. Yeah.
Not even that. It took his, like, I don't know if y'all remember, Sundays was like family day for us. Me and my family, my mom, my brothers and sisters. Yeah. And we would watch Disney movies. It was like a time when Disney movies came on. Like, it was like around from 5 to 6, they had these Disney movies that come on.
Oh, wow.
And you get to watch these movies. And we would watch them. We'd be all in my mom's and dad, king side bed.
Yeah.
Me and my brother's sister were sleeping bags. Mm-hmm. We all watching. And it brought me back to that. That's why I think it had a special place in my heart.
Yeah, for sure. It had that. It definitely had that element to it. Especially with the, like they mentioned, with the black and white.
Yeah.
Especially that it was, you know, you have like the classic monsters. You have werewolf. Yeah. You have the mummy.
The wolf.
Yeah, you have the wolf man.
That's
the
what
mummy.
I got from it.
Yeah, the wolf man. You have the mummy. You had the creature from
the Black Lagoon.
You had Dracula.
Frankenstein,
Bride of Frankenstein, you know, all of the typicals, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And it puts you in that light, the black and white, the Nosferatu type shit, you know what I'm saying? So that's why I think, you know, they just like they mentioned in the article, that was a key element to make you, to draw you in. You're like, whoa, this shit. This is some shit.
They did a really good job, on it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, from front to the beginning and even the plot of, you know, her being like a hunter, monster hunter, and her dad leaving and her mom.
Most definitely.
Yeah, the whole storyline was great.
Yeah. So it says Marvel Studios shared an official announcement confirming that Werewolf by Night, the MCU's first ever special presentation, will be re-released on Disney Plus in color on October 20th.
mm-hmm. noodles.
And it will be fittingly titled Werewolf by Night in Color. I think this is a dope idea.
Just like how they did the original Cinderella and Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, my bad. It was in black and white, and then when they made it in that color, remember that, what was it called? Something color. When they started doing films, like taking the old films and putting them in color, that shit was ill.
Yeah, yeah, they did that with Wizard of Oz and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying?
Technicolor. That's what they did.
Yeah, so, you know, they did that with Wizard of Oz and stuff. And I'm just anxious to see how it would look in color, because it would look dope in black and white. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So the fact that we get to see, like, Man-Thing in color and shit, that's dope. And even though, and we talked about this plenty of times, like I said, I ain't going to dwell on it too much, but I think this is another move due to the strikes.
Yeah.
Of course, you know, to re-up on content, which I don't mind. Like, if you got the content, I'm all about stretching your content as far as you can go. You know what I'm saying? Because it however many times you can reiterate something or whatever,
just as long as it
gives a different effect.
But they're stretching this content, it's showing that they can pay these people.
Exactly.
Like, come on.
Exactly.
Pay these people what they're worth and what for what they're doing.
Yeah.
Exactly. Well, I did see this morning, like I said, my wife and I, we normally get up in the mornings, watch the news. They're coming close to an agreement.
Oh, brother. Okay.
So we're gonna keep our eyes and our ears glued, you know what I'm saying, and peeled to see what's to come. But
yeah,
it's looking like it's on the up and up. We're gonna see.
Hey, listen.
Well, as far as that, I think they know that they come up with something, because the first time, I know all y'all should remember the first strike. All we got was a bunch of reality TV out of that.
Yeah.
I don't think they could do that this time.
No.
They know that they have to, we got to fix this.
Yeah.
And we got to start putting stuff out there.
Exactly.
Now, I'll be honest with you. I didn't realize when I started seeing, people started posting their residual checks and things like that. And I was like,
how can you
live in Hollywood? You know what I'm saying? How can you make it out there? You got episodes where you're only getting like, the episode's like $1.58.
That's crazy.
Yeah, that's wild.
What I'm saying?
Yeah, that's wild.
It's crazy. People get up there. Well, this is my these are my residuals for the past, you know, for this month. $1.58, $2.50, 85 cents. And I'm just like, how can y'all even make a living out there in Hollywood? To be honest with you,
exactly.
That let me know right there that people are either perpetrating that hard, or they got a roommate or something.
Yeah.
You can't make it out there like that. No, really. You can't make it out there. And I'm not necessarily talking about movie stars.
Yeah.
We know everybody get like, you know, Denzel probably gets like $1 million and change.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? For you know, whatever reason. Chris Evans, all those guys are making millions. But the people that are just like on regular TV, like, what does, for instance, what does Tichina Arnold get off of Martin residuals?
Yeah.
Mm. You were just saying that he was out there.
Shoal is swollen, down about your calling. BDB. Hey, BDB. Hey, she had the original. She had the original Badunkadunk for real. Hey,
bro, we got to talk about the strikes.
Let's get back. Let's get back. You know, I lose track, you know, when they got the slim, thick, and tapered ankles.
Goodness.
But she was out there with the signs, as we was talking about that last time. And she was like, you know what? I got to fight for my people. I got to fight for, because all the SAG actors is her people. It ain't no Democrat. We she fighting for everybody. Everybody trying to fight for everybody, and that's what's up.
Yeah, you know, most definitely. But yeah, I'm looking forward to this new Werewolf by Night. I think it's a good look. I love the first one, and I want them to do more of these special presentations, man.
Oh yeah, that'd be nice.
I would like to see more done the way that they did it. I mean, not necessarily the black and white thing, but just like some special one-shot, you know, one-shot.
But that was dope, though, even in black and white. If they do it correctly, like how they did that one, they roll it out
or,
like that.
Yeah,
or
if
cool.
they keep or if they keep it within that same universe, like all the monsters.
Oh,
like,
yeah,
because, you know, Marvel has monsters of their own, you know what I'm saying? So, like, they want to do Man-Thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. They can do Man-Thing, and they possibly do it in black and white. Or if we'll see how it looks in color.
Well, you see how they left it open. They when they went into the tavern, you would see like the different monsters, like their head posted and everything like that. So maybe they can go into the that actual hunter that actually went and hunted that particular monster and go into that storyline for
each
one.
Yeah, they could have their own little. Dope. That would be dope. A Disney Plus Monsters universe.
Oh my goodness, that would be super dope.
Yeah, I mean, because they do have it.
Yeah. And why not? You know what I'm saying?
I didn't even really look at the first Werewolf by Night when I was a kid. I wasn't a big fan of like horror comics, so I wasn't reading Werewolf by Night. Yeah. I wasn't reading Man Thing, and you know, I remember they even had like a Dracula comic from Marvel Comics for a good while. But I'm willing to give it a look now.
Yeah, Blade got to start in Blade, he got to start in a Dracula comic, I believe.
I believe you're correct. Yeah. Sir. Yeah, I believe so.
Yeah, I think he got his.
I believe so. That was his first appearance.
Yeah, in the Dracula comic.
Yeah,
but Blade
was different though. Blade was.
Yeah.
I wouldn't necessarily even call him a superhero per se.
Mm-hmm.
But
anti-hero.
Just giving him the perspective of the one hunting the vampires.
Yeah,
the fact that he was a brother didn't hurt either.
Yeah, Daywalker.
Yeah,
exactly.
But I'm willing to give the Werewolf by Night a look now. I'll definitely consider taking a look at it now that it's especially gonna be in color.
And
things like that. So yeah,
I would suggest you look at the black and white one first. Watch the black and white one, and then before you watch the color one.
Is that black and white?
Yeah, I think it's gonna give you a different.
It give you that old classic horror. Yeah. Like it made me want to go back and watch some old
Mummy.
Yeah, the Mummy or like Nosferatu or whatever. I'm like, yo, let me go back and watch the Bride of Frankenstein.
I'm gonna do that.
Yeah, you know we big horror buffs, Rick, too.
I don't even fuck with horror like that. I ain't gonna hold you, but that shit was wrong.
We big horror buffs. You know that. Like one of the first gifts Rick gave me was.
I just didn't read horror comics.
Yeah. Right.
You know what I mean? I didn't read the horror comics, but I'm definitely down to watch the shows and the movies and things like that. So
exactly.
I'm gonna check out the black and white first.
Exactly. Yeah. One of the first gifts this dude gave me was my whole squad
recommended it. So
the whole set of Tales from the Crypt. You know what I'm saying? That was one of the first. Crypt. Yeah, he gave me all the seasons, bro. Like of Tales from the Crypt. That was one of the first gifts he gave me.
That's dope. We
on that classic shit. But another show that's coming to Disney Plus. Is Loki season 2, and I'm looking forward to that.
Mm-hmm.
But they moved the release date. You know what I'm saying?
And your boy Nas, you shot him out. He said, "I'm the Loki on that Magic 3." He's like, "I'm gonna let you keep going. I'm sorry, no interruptions."
No, you So they recently announced that they moved the Loki premiere date up to October
5th.
I'm cool with that. That's right around the corner anyway. I saw the latest commercial. They talking about they giving my man Jonathan Majors some shine, bro. Like,
oh yeah, you know that.
The coast is clear.
Yeah,
all right, hit the button.
Is old girl gonna be in it? The girl that was in that horror, whatever. Like they had a whole like space thing that was on HBO. She was like a time cop. Going back through time with Loki on the episodes, the black lady. She put on a little bit of weight, but she was the lady from Cadillac Records. I can't think of her name. Oh man. Remember
the time cop?
Yeah, she was like kind of one of the time cops.
I know you're talking about. She played old girl in Lovecraft Country.
Yeah. She was like the auntie mama or something.
Yeah, I forget her name, but...
Is she going to be in this one too? On this season? We don't know.
I do not know.
Because she had like a kind of a detailed like role and place in that, chasing the other Lokis down and whatnot. From what I'm...
She could possibly be. But,
I think they are reprising their roles.
Yeah.
Okay.
So... It says
I'm looking forward to that. And Dub and I talked about this. It might have been like a year ago. Me and Dub talked about this. Are we now going to start seeing movies or shows where they feature villains? You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Loki's got a show. I'm hearing, you know, Craven the Hunter's got a movie.
Mm. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Is this where we start featuring villains? I guess in an outlawish kind of role. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. We've needed that.
Yeah,
like we talked about Thanos. Like these movies and comics are giving these villains a human, like making them human and humanizing them by showing them, okay, there's a fork in the road where every human or every being goes through, which determines which path they take. I could take the sinister path, or I can take this and go another route and be positive with it. And like I said, Thanos, we talked about this on one of the last episodes. He snapped his finger because he felt like the universe wasn't balanced. It was taking too much resources and stuff. So he wanted to make everything balanced. So was he really like a villain? That's the question that they, so yeah, I could see that. Mm-hmm. I love that.
Yeah.
They are definitely humanizing, which is a good word by my man. They're humanizing the villains. They did it with Loki, mm-hmm. Thanos, Killmonger.
Yep.
You know, humanizing them and justifying their actions.
Yeah.
So to speak.
Yeah, I wanna see. I'm anxious to see how this second season of Loki ties into Deadpool. Because I'm hearing a lot of, you know, with all the information that's coming out with Deadpool, I'm hearing a lot of back and forth between, you know, Loki and Deadpool and how, you know, everything dealing with the multiverse.
Really?
And stuff like that.
I'm even trying to see how that matches Loki and Deadpool. I'm trying to, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying to see it. I can't see it right now.
I'm sure they're gonna do their best.
It's gonna be a Deadpool.
But so they you know, Disney Plus has been doing like a new strategy now as far as rollouts of the shows. They just started it with Ahsoka. Mm-hmm. Ahsoka on the Star Wars series.
Mm-hmm.
They're not releasing the whole season. Right off the rip. They're doing it weekly. They're finding better results this way.
When did the whole binge thing really start? Because I think that was done for when we were in lockdown. I want to say that you could really binge something. Well, maybe before, but they've been talked about getting away from the binge watching.
Yeah, so I think they're gonna approach the Loki season 2 the same way.
Mm-hmm.
So you're going to get like, and sometimes they'll throw out like 2 episodes to start off with. Throughout 2, sometimes 3, depending on how many shows are in that particular season.
Mm.
They'll throw out 2, 3. Here you go. Then you got to wait a week. And then it's 1 per week from that point on.
I think with them doing it like that, I think that's kind of like what slowed Secret Invasion for me. I thought Secret Invasion was kind of slow.
Yeah.
It was like a slow burn type thing.
Oh, really?
I'm not saying I didn't like it.
Releasing it one week at a time?
Yeah. Because you definitely had to get through the first couple episodes to kind of where it started getting to a plot. And when you started like...
So you think you would have had a better like outlook on it had it been up there for binge? Like you just...
Nah, because
I would have.
I take it to like with the 50 Cent.
That's just me, but I think so.
Yeah. I think like the Power Universe, like... 50 was getting pissed because he knows it's like the hip hop game. We equated to that. Like, remember we talked about like it used to be big to wait on this album to come to drop, whatever. You know what I'm saying? You get it for like a year later, but you anticipated the new album and they put more into it. It was so much, it was enriched. He had a lot of time and stuff put into it. It was really good album when it came out.
Yeah. But so you know, once again, October says what moves this premiere from October 6th to October 5th at 6 PM PST.
Mm.
With the new episode dropping every Thursday at the same time.
Yeah.
So, you know, definitely looking forward to that. Like I said, you know, the first season was dope. It's probably one of the illest shows so far to me. Out of all the Disney Plus shows, I would say Loki was by far one of the dopest.
That's one you like?
Yeah.
Well, it's going to take us back, Rick. It's going to take us back to them days when we had to wait. to see our favorite, our new episode coming in, you know?
So,
it's definitely part of the ratings game.
Yeah.
That's definitely why they're doing it like that. I think that's why a lot of things stop being bingeable.
Yeah,
right. They'd like to keep people hanging on. Like, we can guarantee this many viewers per week.
Yeah.
Because of this show.
Right. Right.
Because everybody anticipating.
Yeah, because the TV game is changing, and I definitely think Marvel is the leader in that. Yeah.
Right, right, right.
We even equated to, like, Saturday morning cartoons. Remember, like, before school was about to start, they would give you that little promo at night.
Yep.
You know, on Sunday night, they'll give you a little promo of the cartoons that was going to hit on the next Saturday.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
it was
cartoons
like,
had season premiere, had big season premiere and big season rollouts and things like that. Yeah,
exactly.
You're right. You're right.
Exactly. Yeah. So, yeah, you know, definitely looking forward to the Loki season two. And you know what else I'm looking forward to? A break and a word from our sponsor.
Yes, sir.
We'll be right back. Hip Hop Marvel's podcast, your friendly neighborhood plug for all things hip hop and Marvel. But we got it locked from the block to the comic shop. You know what I'm saying? We'll be right back. Are you looking for a sweet treat to brighten up your day? Do you want to support a local black-owned business that makes delicious pastries and snacks? Then you need to check out Hook & Key Creations out of Sanford, North Carolina. Hook & Key Creations offers a variety of mouth-watering goodies with a New Orleans flair. Cupcakes, cakes, cookies, candy apples, candied popcorn, ooey gooey bars, and more. They use fresh ingredients and homemade recipes to make every bite a delight. Whether you need a cake for a special occasion, a snack for your office meeting, or just to treat yourself, Hook & Key Creations has you covered. You can order online, call, or text 919-537-9676 and follow them on Facebook and Instagram to see their latest creations and promotions. Order from Hook & Key Creations today and enjoy a little taste of New Orleans one bite at a time.
What's good? It's your player Ponder 2 Chainz, you feel me? In the building, money all the way to the ceiling.
Hey yo, what up everybody? This is Thigh Home.
Yo, this is Trackstar the DJ.
Hey yo, what's up? Black Shaman, let your constant spirit get down to the south. PFD. This is Paris Pistol, let's get rocking with
PFD. Rocking with Precise Politics.
Yo, 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 what up? This is DJ Eclipse.
Hello everybody, this is Benefit Duval.
It's your boy Sheik Looch. D-Block all day, Silverback Gorillas.
What's good, people? This is Eternal the MC.
What's up? This your boy, Wyclef Jean.
Wyclef Jean.
A.K.A. Spider-Man.
Spider-Man.
You already know I'm a superhero. What makes me a superhero? Come on. Hip-Hop Marvels.
Hip-Hop Marvels.
Hip-hop this is Hip-Hop Marvels.
We are live at Hip-Hop Marvels. So you know how we do. We do all the things at all the time. This is where the superheroes reside. You know what I'm saying?
Hip-Hop Marvels podcast. Keep tuned in because they couldn't have bridged together a better gap.
All
right?
Hip-Hop Marvels podcast. I'm over here marveling at all these dope sounds.
That's the chill. Hip-Hop Marvels.
Right now, I'm checking out Hip-Hop Marvels podcast, available wherever dope podcasts are streamed.
Right now, you're checking out Hip-Hop Marvels podcast.
Keep blazing that shit and all that.
You feel me? You're tuning to
Hip-Hop Marvels podcast.
You on that?
Your friendly neighborhood plug for all things hip-hop and Marvel.
2 Chainz Radio.
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 And we're back, Hip Hop Marvels podcast, your friendly neighborhood plug for all things hip hop and Marvel, where we got it locked from the block to the comic shop. And this is episode 40. What you going on my 40, homie? You know what I'm saying?
What you got on my 40, homie?
You know what I'm saying? And yeah, man. Y'all know what time it is. Yes, yes, y'all.
Yes, yes, y'all. We don't stop.
All right, so Nas, he dropped this Magic 3.
Mm-hmm.
The conclusion.
Mm.
To the trilogy.
into the, what, 6 year? No, the six three album, year. 3 year run.
Yeah.
What should he say?
What he equated it to? He says Star Wars and Furious.
Star Wars and the Fast and Furious franchise. He said the box sets.
The box sets. Hey, that's tangible too. Like if he do that, I'm gonna buy it. May you make all six albums a tangible CD, cassette, or something like. I'm gonna buy it, Nas. Hey,
he's gonna do it,
man.
Nas is a smart guy. He's gonna do that. And he might throw some extra shit on there too, some extra tracks, some instrumentals.
Make it tangible, like make it something like the box, the art, everything. You know, I'm gonna buy it. I don't care. I'm gonna buy it.
So Magic 3 dropped. What are y'all? Don't all just flood it at once. What are y'all thoughts,
man? What I gotta say about Nas is
what are your thoughts? Album. Where you rank it? Let's see, favorite track.
Do I rank it out of all the six?
Out of just the Magics.
Out of just the Magics,
and then all the six. Yeah.
So I gotta go Magic 1, then 3.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Then 2. All right.
Yeah.
That's how I feel about it, you know, because it seemed like the Magics, the way he made the Magics was to sound a certain way, and then with 3, it just sounded, you know, more like a...
3 sounded more like it could have been a King's Disease.
Yeah, there it is.
You know what I'm saying? 3, because, you know, the Magics... Okay, here was my assessment. My assessment was the King's Diseases were his, like, you know, album... some radio ready, more commercialized, more substance, you know, tracks. The Magics were a way to get his shit off. You know, they were more boom bappy to me, a little bit more hip hop. You know what I'm saying? That's my assessment between the Magics and the KDs. Now, like you said, KD, 1, 2, and 3. The order is a little, it's crazy because I got the order of the KDs and the order of the Magic are the same for me.
Same for me.
And that's 1, 3, 2.
Mm-hmm.
1, 3, 2, 1, 3, 2 across the board, you know? But yeah, like you said, for Magic 3, it sounded, you know, it sounded a little more, KD-ish to me. But nonetheless, great project. We were just talking, saying that, you know, we were asking each other, do we think these are classics?
Most definitely.
Does he have 6 classics on his hand? And by my criteria, I think he does, man.
Yeah.
By my criteria.
There's no question about that.
By my criteria.
I'm with you 100%. I can't be mad at none of that.
Because the subject matter and what he's speaking on is so relevant. To the time and what's going on,
right?
So, you know, it's a breath of fresh air compared to us hearing the same stuff recycled, oversaturated
over and over again.
Over and over again.
And Jay, you wrong for trying to drop when my man was dropping his albums on the sneak tip. Jay, cut that out, blood.
What do you think, man?
For me, I got different order. On the Magics, I got 3, maybe 1, then 2. And then on the King Disease, I got 2 just by a margin, but 3, I'm really loving 3.
So you're going 2-3-1?
2-3-1 on the King Disease. On the Magics, I'm going 3-2-1.
3-2-1.
3-2-1. 3, this Magics, this new one he put out, I don't know. If he just put it out for me, I'm going to say you just put it out for me.
Rick, what's your opinion?
I think mine is pretty much like everybody else's. The first Magic and the first KDs are the best.
Yeah.
And then 3 and then 2. I'm still soaking in 3. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to just give it a number 2 ranking like that, but I definitely... It seemed like with 3, knowing 3 is going to be the last one. It's like he definitely put his best foot forward.
Right, on purpose. On 3. Purposefully.
1-800-NAS and hit. Oh, man.
Yeah, what are some of the standout tracks, man? That's no one tears. That's one for me.
Speechless.
He spoke
speechless too. He spoke to everything we said on, like, I think podcast 37.
Yeah.
Volume 537. He spoke to everything that we said about AI.
But yeah, oh yeah, he surely did.
Yeah.
But the whole algorithm binary code thing.
And him and Lil Wayne killed it. I can't, like, Lil Wayne moved up some. He moved up to my my greatest of all
everybody moving up. Nobody has a steady slot on your list, bro.
Man,
everybody's moving up, huh?
Man, that song. What's the name of the song to him and what's it called? We'll Never Die.
Never Die.
Never Die. Oh, man. I wasn't expecting that from Lil Weezy. I was like, the beat hard. But Lil Weezy came. Oh, my God. Hey, he moved me a little bit.
Yeah.
He definitely came up.
Tune definitely did his thing on that one. Yeah. Nas did too. Can't forget Nas. But Nas, Nas.
He's going to do that.
Yeah, he's going to do that. That's him. Yeah. He's automatically going to
do that. It's got to be Speechless. It's got to be Speechless for me, too.
Speechless was definitely the standout. Speechless was the standout.
And don't sleep on Fever, because Fever, that was the first one. That made me a believer when I heard Fever.
The first track.
Fever.
Yeah, Fever. Yeah. Yeah, he got some, definitely got some joints.
Shout out to Hit-Boy. Hit-Boy in the production. Oh, my God.
Every last song I can listen to. Tisk.
Yeah.
It's really no skips.
Yeah, it's no skips.
That's
a
classic. Yeah.
Like this, it's a classic. It was like that with me with all of them. I mean, some people could argue little to no skips. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But I mean, the overall, man, like if you average all six of them joints out, he got that's a good run, if I say so.
Man.
You know, it's a good run.
Six albums in 3 years. And most artists don't do six albums in no years.
Nah. Right.
Nah.
You know.
That's true that. True that.
Yeah.
True that.
You know, so. And then all around.
I think he's had so much to say. He's had so much bottled up, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he needed somebody more than just Primo. Don't get me wrong. Primo is the shit.
Oh, yeah.
Him and Nas together. But I think he has so much to say. But you want to go with a different backdrop to it.
Yeah.
Right. And this is all around the same time that, you know, he's turning 50 he turned 50. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, he gifted us.
Gifted us a birthday gift.
Hell,
you know what I'm saying? Ironic, he's turning 50 the same year as hip hop. And he's like, he embodies hip hop and he has arguably like his first album, Illmatic, is is related to as the hip hop Bible. Mm-hmm. So
like, if anybody can get with Nas and y'all find him and he do us that six album compilation and he put it together, send it to us at Hip Hop Marvels Podcast.
The only other person we're
gonna put it up
like that is Hov.
Right.
The only other artist I see actually doing
can
that
do
right
can do yeah,
he can do
that.
It, but like doing really that. Is like Hov really is his heart still in it like that?
He don't need to.
Nah, he don't need to.
But Nas didn't need to. Nas got money like that now,
too. He just
too,
wanted
you know
to
saying?
For the love of the art.
But like,
wanted to.
So you saying Jay don't got that same love, though?
Nah, I'm not saying he don't got that same love, but it ain't as important to him now than it was.
Because remember LL kind of calling him out on that, on the 50 years of hip-hop, and was like, hey, you know, some of us out here thinking we too good to get up on stage and stuff. So I'm like wondering if we gonna it's a hidden Jay out gym out there coming.
Jay is a businessman.
And he might think he too good, but that don't mean he don't love hip-hop.
Yeah.
Tell me I don't love hip-hop because I don't want to do hip-hop. Like,
but I'm gonna tell you like this. I produce and engineer and all that. I don't never want to be seen. I don't want to do anything.
Right. Like, just because I don't want to do, you know what I'm saying?
But you don't have to be seen, but, like, you know what I'm saying?
He made it. Look, he has the Book of Hov exhibit up right now. So he go got see
so
my shit.
So
I contributed.
So what are we giving? What are we giving? We giving,
you know what I'm saying?
We can't give Hov a pass. As much as I love Hov is my, He right outside my top 10, bumping maybe 11 or 12.
What is there in the past?
Nah, we can't give him a pass. We need a whole album. I'm calling you out, ho. H, you got your own lane? Show me your own lane. Because Nas just showed us. Nas just showed us his own lane.
He's done that. No, I'm talking about.
Look, I need a new hoe. I'm selfish, y'all. I'm being selfish, ho. But come on, blood. Give us something, B. I need a new allure type of, like, just you talking your ish, like, well, in allure. He said my women friends get tennis braces, get their windows replaced with the sun. It ain't even fun no more. I'm jaded, man. It's just a game. I just play it to play. I need some of that Jay. What y'all thinking? I mean, am I here alone?
I mean, you said you need new Jay.
You need new Jay. Hey, that's, but listen,
Jay can give us some. He can give us that ism, just like that with the new Jay. Hey, look, this nigga the head of music of the NFL. Give us some. Talk your shit, Jay.
That's what I'm saying. He's got so much going on
that he don't have to.
Man,
do. You got pretty much. Look, you pretty much telling us. What we Jay saying? Like, what we're arguing?
I'm upset, bro. Like Drake right now, Jay. I'm upset like Drake
like
right
now. I'm a business man.
Hey,
yeah.
I don't care how much business you got. You got enough
I'm
room
not
for
a
hip hop,
man. I'm a business
LL
man.
Put the pressure on him, LL. Nas, put the pressure on him.
You know. But yeah, back to Nas, man.
Between Nas and Jay, Nas is quiet money. Nas is quiet money.
Yeah.
Jay wants you to know this is what I am doing. I'm rubbing elbows with Dershowitz and cats like that right now. He wants you to know that. Nas just rather sit back there and make his money to the side and put out quality hip hop material. Mm-hmm. Not saying Jay doesn't put out quality, but that's just like their different strategies in the game.
Oh yeah.
But that's even more for us to ask for Jay to give us something, you know what I'm saying? To give us something like Jay, I don't think Jay is ever too big for hip hop. You know what I'm saying? Because hip hop was here before him, is gonna be here after him. So he's no individual Nas and even number one Biggie. I know y'all saying, but you know what I'm saying? I don't think it's too big for nobody though, for real. I think Jay can do it. And a lot of it, I'm just being selfish because I want to hear a Jay album. And I'm just being selfish and I'm talking shit. But a big part of me is saying I need a
please do an album.
I need it. Just like I needed that Nas. I need that Magic 3.
Album.
I need
give
that.
Ah,
man.
Just for E.
Oh, man.
Jay is capable, just like Nas
is extremely capable.
Yeah, but it's a question of do Jay want to do that? And I don't think he wants to. And quite frankly, he has his hands in so much other, you know, in so many different businesses. It don't seem like the right thing to do right now.
But
I mean,
come on now.
He might not be totally focused. Now he can come out of the woodwork and hit you every other, you know, every so often with a verse or something like that. That's cool. Look at Andre. Look at Three Stacks. He do it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But hold up. Three Stacks is also working on
the album right now too.
I'm not giving.
We heard that from Killer Mike.
Killer
Mike was saying that Andre is working on the album right now.
Oh, he was trolling.
Then he said he was bullshit.
He was bullshit. Yeah, he was trolling with that.
But now y'all giving Jay a pass, or y'all underrating Jay for me?
No.
Y'all saying that he can't. No. Listen, hear me out. Hear me out. What I'm gonna say for y'all? Y'all jump kill me. But nah, I'm saying like y'all saying Jay can't do business and make a quality hip hop album. I think he did it with the Blueprint. I think he did it with the Black Album. I think he did it with when he was messing with Kanye, because he was making billions back then when he did this.
No, it wasn't. That's the point. And that's what I was going to say. No, he wasn't a billionaire.
He wasn't touching billions.
He wasn't a businessman that he is now when he did those albums.
That's what I'm saying.
But I mean, it's more money equated to it, but he was still doing the same business deals and stuff like that. Y'all saying he wasn't doing business like that?
No, he was doing business, but it's. The business has grown. He's doing more business now than he was then.
Exactly.
But when you got like that kind of business going on, you got other people.
Brunches.
You are doing other things. You're delegating these
obligations to these people, to you creating these CEOs to run these corporations for you, and they reporting it and you getting the name front of it, but you're not actually doing the
he might be hands on.
No, he sounds like to me he's hands on. Like the NFL stuff.
Okay.
He got, you know, the liquor stuff he does stuff. Yeah, the you know what I'm saying, the whole Budweiser thing he's doing.
And also with that, I think that's the mistake he made before with Rockefeller. He wasn't very hands-on with
Rock
Rockefeller.
Nation.
He
I left forgot it about up that. To, Rock,
to, he's left it up to Dame and Biggs. So he doesn't want to see another business that he's attached to or at least got his name on go that route.
He's
so
more hands-on now.
Hands-on.
Yeah, he's but more hands-on now.
But you got to understand with the liquor thing, he is not a owner of the liquor. He's licensing that alcohol. That champagne was already there. Somebody already run it. He's doing a licensing deal. So a lot of these things, he's not... I'm not saying he's not hands-on with it, but he's not doing the legwork.
Okay, and that could very well be the case, but he's not just going to leave it. Like, if you had, you go every other, so often you're going to go to the meetings.
Yeah.
You're going to go.
Yeah, of course you want to know what's going on.
Yeah, you still got to be in the know.
Yeah.
But you think that 50, like, and I've watched some of the 50, but even with the power where he got his producer and stuff like that. He'll get into someone and say, oh, I think this person in this role should be moving more like this, but y'all doing good. Go ahead. You know what I'm saying?
I feel you. I get what you're saying.
If your team is like that, then yeah, but I still think he definitely pokes his head in the room more than he's ever done before.
Right. And due to that, the last thing on his mind is making an album. Look at Rihanna.
Yeah.
That's a prime example. Look at Rihanna. I don't think she's trying to make babies though.
She's trying to have her family.
But even before she got with ASAP,
she got Fenty.
She got business. Of course, yeah.
But you understand, when she did her last album, she was still doing that business. She was still making billions off of that bikini line
but,
and shit.
Right, but
nobody just
big,
didn't know.
But it's not as big as it is since that album. Now
it's been a minute, yeah.
Yeah, it's not as big as it is now.
I'm just saying, Jay can make an album. Jay. I'm being selfish.
He trying to find any excuse.
Yeah, yeah. I'm not gonna put no cap on what you can do, Jay. I think you can run the business and put a quality album that's just as dope as Magic 3, if not better. I'm gonna say right now Magic 3 is better than what you got out here, Jay. So prove me wrong.
Prove me wrong, baby.
You gotta be focused. When Nas is doing business, you don't hear from Nas. Nas goes dark. When Nas is focusing on the business.
So and when he come out of the woodwork,
he's
good.
What you mean? The dude just tells you that's fallacy right there. He just gave us six quality albums right now. Mm-hmm. And he gave us one before that. Then he also gave us the Lost Tapes album. He gave us that tape, the album he did with Kanye, where Nasir album, we had like six joints on it. That was a quality album with Not For Radio and all them. Then he gave us the other joint.
But like I said, Nas is focused on those records. When he's focused, that's when Nas is on the best. The quality of KD and Magic, that shows you he was completely focused.
So you're saying that Jay can't be as focused even with this stuff going on?
He's going to have to lead.
He can be.
But he probably don't want to be.
I think Nas's love for the art is way more.
You get what I'm saying?
Passion has way more passion than.
And
what
it
Jay
takes
does.
Nothing.
I'm not gonna give y'all that. I'm not gonna say that Jay ain't got his heart into it like that.
Don't take nothing from Jay either.
At all, no.
To me, it do.
He just so happened. He just so happened to value the. Because either way, the businesses have sprouted from hip-hop.
Yeah.
So he just so happened to be indulged in more of the business aspect more so than the music. Mm. And if both of them had, like, counters or they both had, like, different levers that you can raise and, you know what I'm saying? Jay-Z's lever would be slightly more raised in the business aspect than Nas's, and Nas's music would be slightly, you know what I'm saying, mm-hmm. more raised than Jay-Z's, you know what I'm saying, because that's just where they're at in life right now, you know what I mean?
I could see what you're saying.
Bro, the last album he put out was 444.
I see what you're saying.
The last solo album he put out was 444. That was what, in 2017?
But didn't him and 2018? Beyonce put an album together like a couple years, like a year ago?
Yeah, but him, that was him and Beyonce though.
So you saying that he need Beyonce? So no, y'all killing my man Jay right now. I'm telling you. Y'all killing my man Jay. Y'all proving Dame right. Y'all proving a lot of cats right.
He put words in my mouth. Because
Dame said that. Hey, he had that. And 50 was like, because he had that woman. That's how
I
he
never
got.
I never said that.
Well, all I'm saying is, I think Jay can do it. I think Jay can do it.
But
y'all killing my man Jay. Jay, give me an album. Make me right, Jay.
But like,
that's what we're not saying. We're not saying Jay can't do it. We're saying Jay has to be focused.
He had to be focused. And right now,
music is not going to be there.
Right, right. And right now,
looking at
Nas was completely
focused. I'm looking at you, Jay.
Nas got dope. Nas got dope albums.
He could, yeah.
I'm looking at you, Jay. I'm calling you out. I'm looking at you right now. I'm calling you out, Jay. Can you get focused with all the billions you make?
And also, you got to remember this too. Nas put out Illmatic. Nas was 18, 19 years old. Jay put out Reasonable Doubt. Jay was 25, 26.
But he also put out with Jazzo, with a Hawaiian Sophie. He was a teenager too. Then.
That was a co-pilot role. That was a co-pilot role with Jazz. When you the front man, when your name is in the marquee, you have to be focused. And Jay even talked about he had to leave the streets alone for a little bit just to accomplish Reasonable Doubt.
So y'all telling me that Jay got a complex when he can't focus.
We off on a tangent here. Look, I don't know how we got here.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
We supposed to be talking about Nas. We got on. We on Jay. But no. So
Jay made
Nas. You know, he turned 50. You know, like I said, which is ironic. And you know, he had a star-studded birthday. You know, he had everybody from Kendrick Lamar and Mary J.
Happy birthday, Ken Folk.
Diddy. You know, they all came out. And I thought it was just clever and dope for him to drop Magic 3.
And thank you for the
conclusion.
The
conclusion of his trilogy, you know, around his birthday. You know what I mean? I thought it was dope.
Jay, you can give me a gift too. Make that album, Jay. Make that album, Jay.
Man, so we gonna move on. And with that said, we're gonna
let me say this too. We're seeing Nas. Nobody knew what a 50-year-old rapper looked like. Nobody.
True.
You are now witnessing what a 50-year-old rapper is and what a 50-year-old rapper can do.
Mm-hmm. But Nas don't look 50 either. Nas, you know, black don't crack.
I'm not talking about the look. I'm just talking about the fact that at the age of 50.
I know what you're talking about. But I'm
he
just
can
throwing
bring,
that.
He can bring what hip-hop is. Anybody I say that's an MC, I don't care if it's Lil Wayne to Nelly. Right. If you call yourself an MC, there needs to be an album that's made for the culture.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Nas has done that six deep.
Yeah.
Right. And he speaks to it. He said he's talking to the young boys and the old cats. He said, "Look, I ain't trying to push you out the way. I'm in my own. I'm over here on the side. I just did this because out of the love." He said in this three. That's why I appreciate Magic 3. I love it, Jay. I'm waiting for yours. Leave it alone.
I just want to send a big shout out to Jarrell Gant. He's an artist, and he pretty much, because there was a picture floating around online of I guess it was photoshopped or something like that. It was a picture floating around of Nas, of the infamous Michael Jordan six ring picture.
That was dope.
And you know, someone had photoshopped Nas's face or whatever. So, you know, this artist Jarrell Gant took it upon himself to paint said picture, and within the six rings, he put all six of Nas's rings, which is fire.
With the album covers on them.
Yeah, the album covers. You know, so shit was fire, man. Y'all go by his page on Instagram. It's at Imitation by Jarrell. That's J-E-R-E-L-L. His name is Jarrell Gant. Big shout out. Big shout out to you,
I gotta check that out.
He's selling prints, and the prints are sold out right now. I think he's gonna re-up some more. I plan on getting me a print to celebrate, you know, Nas and his accomplishment with two trilogies in 3 years, bro. Like, otherworldly.
Nas, Jay.
If anything,
so we're talking at an average about two a year.
Right.
Two within the last 3 years.
Which defutes Jay-Z's math on takeover. You know what I'm saying? Because now, if anything, it added six more classics to his catalog. You know what I'm saying? Yep. Mm-hmm. If anything.
Be honest, right now, Jay got to play catch up.
Yeah.
That's why I'm calling Jay out. Jay, yeah,
music
jump into my top 10, Jay.
Music wise, now as MC as a whole, like artist, MC as a whole, if we're talking businesses and everything else, all types of endeavors, Jay-Z got him, you know, he laps him. But
are we sure about that?
Are we talking music?
Because Nas don't talk about his money, but are we sure about that?
No, we sure about that.
Nas is hitting billions. Yeah. Nas hitting billions, B.
No, I'm talking about when it comes to money, though.
Yeah, money.
Yeah, even if Nas is hitting billions, Jay is way he's light years ahead of him, man. Like, hate to say it.
The dude got houses on all kinds of coasts. Yeah. He got a West Coast crib. He got an East Coast crib. He got a city crib.
Yeah,
he got a suburb crib.
Yeah.
I'm not counting out Nas like with that.
I'm not saying I'm never counting him out. I'm just saying that we're comparing. I'm just saying how when it comes to music, Nas laps Jay-Z, but when it comes to business, Jay-Z laps Nas. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah. Yeah, because Jay been in business longer than Nas.
I mean, I'm gonna say this my man's Dub.
I'm not saying he don't have Rick the any ruler,
business. All of T-Dub, Brandis, I love everybody, and we're not always gonna agree on everything, and that's good though, because it's gonna be some people that's team Filmo Thick, and it's gonna be some team Dub Floyd in them. But I'm just telling you, I don't think, and I'm gonna stick just like y'all be holding on your man Drake. I'm not holding on to Nas about that business. Maybe 5 years ago, 5 years ago, I would say yeah. But now, they teach the Illmatic album at Duke University right there with a college professor at Duke. That's an Ivy League school. Dude is in the Congress, Library of Congress. He got a Pulitzer. Come on, man. And he got an honorary doctorate from Harvard. Come on, bro. I'm just saying.
I'm going to tell you one thing that he don't got.
What?
His own exhibit at a Brooklyn library.
He's partner.
He don't got. You know what I'm saying? And that's just what maybe the first, this maybe with six of his albums that he put out before this six that Nas did.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm, it just, I, hey, look.
Let's look at it this. Let's look at it this way.
Yeah.
How long is that exhibit? Right, how long is that exhibit going to be there? And how long is Nas going to be in the Library of Congress forever? How long is he going to be an honorary?
Jay's in the Library of Congress too.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
What album?
That's not talking about business though.
Yeah, that's exactly what I'm saying.
But that is part of business. He named it
accolades.
About.
They ain't got nothing to do with business.
Yeah, accolade to be in the Library of Congress.
Yeah, but that equates to
dream
him.
Dream about, I'm up in the Library of Congress. Yeah, nobody dreams about that, but it's an accolade.
Yeah.
But that equates to him being a businessman too, because like with them rings and like him having the Queenbridge Investment Group, they making money off of that. He got his partners together with him and they invested their money. And that's what I'm saying. He on the billionaire track. He ain't saying it like Jay let you know. Jay, right. One of them dudes, he want to let you know I got it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
You know, but Nas,
like I said, Nas is quiet money. Nas is quiet.
Just letting y'all know, the Droppin' Gems done bleeded. This is done bleeded into bad. No. This was the Droppin' Gems. We had a different, subject for y'all, but we're going to cover that in another.
Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, guys.
We good, but both dope lyricists, both dope MCs, both dope businessmen.
Without question.
Yeah.
Not taking nothing away from none of them. We just want to, celebrate Nas.
But Nas lapping Jay right now. I need an album, Jay.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But E, I know you got some events coming up.
Oh, yeah, I do. In North Cackalack, the Bull City. Take the Bull City by the horns. We got the Comic-Con and the Bull City November 4th through the 5th. everybody show up and show out. We also got, come on, should I say? Oh, damn. My homeboy. My homeboy's in the Bull City. October 7th, we got the Made in Durham Little Brother Block Party. Man, quick thing. Little Brother and them was one of the reasons why I moved to North Carolina. Them, Rhapsody, and Ninth Wonder, because they was holding it down with hip hop in the South. That's it.
All right, and that's the Nexus events, you know what I'm saying, with the boy E-Ray, you know what I mean? Rick!
Shout out Wally Sparks, who will be attendance there at the Little Brother Block Party.
Yeah, yes, most definitely, yes. That's my brother Wally, DJ Hourglass, shout out the Crit, who else we got? Zoe and Tall, Black Guy. Yeah. Cool kids.
Where they been? I ain't heard from Cool Kids in some
I have something going on.
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Fontaine Pool, man. They just dropped two new joints today.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah.
Well, not today, but you know, they dropped two new joints. We've been listening to them earlier today.
Yeah.
Wish me well, and what was it?
Glory.
Yeah.
Crazy joints, you know what I'm saying? Man. So shout out to Pooh.
And I told you, I think they're gonna drop Fonte a new album probably at that block party.
They that got you.
That would be ill.
That would be dope.
That would be dope.
Please gift us Little Brother with the album. I look, like Jay.
Dude, he just won the album.
I like Jay.
He just won the album, you know what I'm saying?
Hey, we gotta let them know that it's still cats out here, it's heads out here that still appreciate them and want them. And want their albums. I think a lot of times they don't think that they got a, you know, fan base or audience that, nigga, you got one. Hip hop marvels. But hey, look, go ahead. Shit.
Yeah, man. So, Rick, you got something for us?
Yeah, today it's not necessarily a hip hop, did you know? This is more like a day in hip hop history. Mm. So on September 21st, 1993, De La Soul released their third album, Balloon Mind State, which personally is one of my favorite albums.
What's crazy is I just saw it.
The singles Break of Dawn, Eagle Trip Part 3, which is one of my favorite songs, actually.
Yes, indeed. So, I just saw it on the DSP.
And with them recently just getting their, you know, their publishing back, they're on the fourth tour with LL Cool J right now.
Yeah.
And they're still representing, unfortunately, now as a duo due to the passing of Day.
Yeah.
Right.
Paz and DJ Maceo are still representing De La Soul as a duo. Right. So if y'all ever get a chance to catch them at a show, they've mastered the art of the show. If you understand what I'm saying, they definitely De La Soul, and they'll tell you themselves, they went from being whack showmen in the beginning from the first album to now, they've mastered that.
And shout out to Maceo, man. He had a heartfelt, like, he was on Talib's show, and they were outside, and he was like, he broke down crying, man. It jerked some tears out of me, man, for the love he had for his brother. Man, my heart go out to him, Maceo, and Plug One.
Yeah, most definitely, man.
You were able to create as a friend. They were friends first, before the music. They were friends, and they continued to be friends until Dave's unfortunate passing.
Yeah.
So you know you have something when you can be this person's friend and then be this person's, basically, their work partner for over 30, 40 years.
Yeah.
That's something I think that they should be proud of, and I think people need to applaud them for and continue to enjoy the music.
Yeah,
and you never heard about no beef between them either. You know what I'm saying? Like, you heard of like even little tiny breakups. Little fractures.
And if there was, it was like we stated earlier. They kept it between them, like we said earlier. Any relationship, I don't care if it's a relationship between friends, a marital relationship, whether you're dating or whatever the case may be.
Mm-hmm.
Keep that business to yourself, man. Keep it to yourself.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying? So, yeah. Before we get out of here, y'all want to plug anything? Y'all good? Y'all got anything to?
I'm good.
Lionhead Circle, Filmo Thick. You might have the apparel. Like I said, I'm still searching, making sure the materials is right. I don't want to get out no whack shit. That's pretty much it. I'm getting my art.
All right, that's what's up. Rick, you good?
Just shout out to the other members, Brandis, Jigpool. We were all supposed to be here today. I'm looking forward to the full squad being here today. So we still got more time. We still got some more chances coming up. So looking forward to working with them. And thanks to you guys, like I said before, I'm saying it now, for holding the squad down and holding my man Dub down until I was able to come back. So I definitely appreciate that from you guys and everything.
Most definitely.
I appreciate you guys letting us come in. I told them before I gave y'all flowers, man. I appreciate y'all letting me be a part of this. This is like, you don't like work nothing. I enjoy myself around my brother, my kindred, my kinfolk, my player partners. It's all good.
Most definitely. So, yeah, remember to listen, share, rate, subscribe. Well, wherever you get your podcasts, across the board on all, you know, social media and podcast platforms and apps. You know what I'm saying? Get at us at Hip Hop Marvels. You know what I'm saying?
Holler back.
Subscribe, you know, partners. Subscribe. Y'all, if y'all like, subscribe. Follow all of us.
Yes.
Subscribe.
Hit us up, man. Like I said, we still chemistry. We still building it.
Yeah.
But grow with us. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And don't forget to check out the YouTube. We got content up there damn near weekly. So
yeah,
continue to check that out and subscribe. Click the bell. You get alerted on whenever we make new posts, you know. So
Jay, yeah. I need that album, Jay. That's all I'm saying. Jay, I need that album.
This guy. So until next time, until next episode, this is Hip Hop Marvels Podcast, your friendly neighborhood plug for all things hip hop and Marvel, where we got a lot from the block to the comic shop. Until next time, until next episode.
You a genius, Wizzy. You a genius, Dub. You a genius, Rick. You a genius, Pat. You a genius, Bridget. You a genius, E. You a genius, Hip Hop Marvels. I'm out. 's partner.
We got it locked from your block to the comic shop.
Peedi, Peedi, your girl see me. She know my name, she gon' hit me up tomorrow. Fresh Prince, you know we can't take it if we don't bubble. And you know me, I'm out of the ordinary, I'm rather extraordinary. My diamonds is all canary, we getting money. Genius, and I continue to get that paper. So won't you mind your business, don't be a fucking hater.
Crack, I need that, you got the remedy.
You look surprised, man, I gotta refresh in your memory. Get through, get it, mujer, tell me what you want. But before I could blow my lie, baby, lit up the brand new funk. You know what's gonna happen. I'ma tap Charlie Mack and he gonna smack your ass halfway across bro and Allegheny. No Alize and Henny, just down peeing strawberries for the hottest lady. You got a body, baby. So Jazzy Jeff, how you riding, baby? Yo Jeff, you think she got it?
Yeah, she got it, Peedi.
Whoa, she make me wanna. But before this party get started, let your boy hit that brand new funk. Pete Crakk, Philly, who are around with me? What, so up, young buck, ain't nothing to me. I got bullies, semi-arties, it's on, homie. I brought armor for drama, you ain't got nothing for me. Go in my zone when I write. It's not surprising, you hear my flow and wanna bite. My only options, to dust the dirt off my shoulders, is Rockefeller. I thought you know by now, I ride with hoe and niggas and jealous when they see me in that Bentley, Pirelli's, it's sitting suspension, it's all 26s. Bitches blowing me kisses, my forces is crispy, the Christmas just as cold as my wrists. Stopping folks for the pitches, then continue to keep on sipping. It's the prince of the rock. Jazzy Jeff got the beat locked. I learned this twist from Will Smith. I need not to explain why I got a front. It's not a game. Get a Philly blunt, fill it up with some brand new funk.
Now turn it all around. First the original, then here comes some North Philly chemical with Peedi the Imperial Prince through your stereo. Stupid, I get paid for conversations. It's easy, but I see you having complications. Get it together, you ain't never gonna be better. Got it sewn like a sweater, make me ruffle up your feathers. Keep pulling up publicity stunts. I'ma slap your ass silly with that North Philly brand new phone.
Strictly for cream team, battle a ring, rattling microphone fiends, clean splatter, a king of the throne, bringing it home five nights, up in the source, five mics, whipping the Porsche, high price, pumping the 9-7, rhyme heaven, the voice is mind bending, imagine the Angie, nothing but panties in my 9-11, that's why I'm repping the Doug, checking the club, stepping the mug, with less than the scud, I'm splitting your rug, it's just I'm in love with Mrs. Martinez, Latin goddess of Venus, it just happened to give me the hardest. You wanna see us apart, you're chasing the dark. Don't ask you won the battle, she got a place in my heart.
All of a sudden, the big question is, yo, who this bitch reminisce? Is she really thorough with bubbles? Who she represent? Do Remy write every line and every rhyme that she spit? Is she really the shit? Is her flow really sick? Get off my dick, keep your sorry ass compliments. I get mad quick, I know Remy ain't got no sense. Bitch, don't try to play me, because you not a player. Believe me, you don't really wanna see my gangster. It's easy to cop back and smack the shit out of hoe. Had to leave niggas bleeding just so we could get our dough. They get me heated, that's why I wild out for no reason. On the Bruckner, like fuck you, getting weeded and speeding. I'm a touchable nigga, I ain't never have love with you niggas. Cause y'all pussy, that's why I ain't never fuck with you niggas. Motherfuckers, a scandal, on the avenue of Randall. Don't slip into some shit you and your clique can't really handle. I ain't having it, get the cash out the cabinet before I stab the bastard, baby in the bassinet out. Body a body boy, blow his gut open, leave son choking, gun still smoking. Know how many niggas like I bet you pun loaded. Y'all can all take a dirty dildo and deep throat it.
Oh. Allegedly, they figured out that I'm the secret recipe. The baddest hoes gon' test to eat and blame the high for wanting sex. I never wanted peace, fuck all the ops, I support Malcolm X. The stack of chains is just a front, overtaxed and underwhelming. Your jeweler pulled a major stunt, I don't smoke weed, already blunt. All of my cars I had to hunt, my dog is young as hell, but still a stealth. We call him baby runt, like window shoppers. I see through every front, I speak out what I need. I post seek everything I want, I block out anything I hate. It's still the homie, still unpaid, the notice when I'm seen, the tenants too relaxed, the standards half collapsed. They wrote me in with lame, they treat me like I'm them. They hate I overcame, refuse to pat my back, refuse to shake my hand, refuse to give me props when I am not around, refuse to act like I ain't shit the sound, like I ain't push the culture, like several vultures ain't come after me. Like several vultures ain't come after me. Still I keep it pee, yeah we still digress. And I'm playing checkers, ain't playing chess. Cause I don't go around on niggas, we go over niggas. I'll show you niggas, I'm personally nothing like you. And plus I never liked you. I'm rich as hell, I'd never fight you. I'll have somebody snipe you. My doggy lucky on the edge, holding on by a thread. Just like a kite, it wouldn't cost a price. And even if it did, it'd always be right. Just like I'm Bob Barker. When I speak, pay attention. Go over my words like highlight markers. My only celebrity crush is Nikki Parker. They said I got a type. Said all my hoes, they look the same. They said they look too light. Pee my cup, bet you couldn't tell that it was Sprite. I give a fuck about her face. She walking with a Bamski, I'ma strike.
Yeah. I'ma strike.
Sus.
I'ma strike, Cole and Yachty coming for their respect. Come and pay your debt, just like a travel pillar. We at your neck for the way you slept. It's nuanced, but I see hella influence in the way you dress, the way you sound, the way you try to move. and try to stay abreast on all the latest flows and latest tones from Generation Next. Y'all chasing relevance is evidenced by the way you step. As for me, I cook so masterfully, ain't gotta pay a chef. I'm older now, but still I'm cutting edge. I'm like a bayonet from out the veil. We OSHA certified, you gotta wear your vest. Too many homicides, a lot of sliding, they good at making decks. Thanks to God, I made it out the city. Most would say I'm blessed, my greatest flex is that I made a milli. Feel like I'm Bangladesh, I hate the press, refusing interviews whenever they request. Niggas fake, progressive and woke, I started saying less. I had to stop it, peaked how they profit off of racial stress. Some activists got so rich they probably wish we stay oppressed. Studio steppers moving extra on songs faking rep. Only breaking bad in the lab, thought y'all was making meth. Niggas making threats and I laugh, that's cause you ain't a threat. Don't ask how I feel about no rappers, shit they okay I guess. Incoming car, press the button, the one that say accept. He FaceTimed to ask for a feature and saw the face of death. I'm on your song, your streams going up, not quite the Drake effect. But don't complain, bitch, take what you get and cut the label check. My table set, I dine on your favorite, one verse will take his breath. I probably put more niggas on pause than Cam and Mason Beth. My agent get a whole lot of calls, it's like he paid the ref. These bitches out here looking like Steph on a late contest, wide open shooting they shot, don't even waste your breath. I been stopped fucking you thoughts, ain't got no patience left. Say that shit for one of them niggas that rock the fake protects. My paper stretch just like a Laker before he break a sweat. Sign, the greatest yet.
Stop the beat, let's get something to eat. If she tryna set a trap, then it's gonna work. I love you and all your baddie friends, boo, let's go to Turks. I don't want your Insta or your Snapchat. Add me on your Finsta where you be bad at. She don't want no more love and I don't mind. She's here for a good time, not a long time. I told her after we get done, we can island hop. A friend told me, nigga, shut up, it's shot o'clock.
Girls, 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 girls. Girls all over the world. She's a vibe and her friends a vibe, and we bout to have some fun. Bad bitches round the world, better grab your one.
Girls, girls, oh. Girls, girls, girls all over the world. The world, the world.
Michigan, Atlanta, Florida, Alabama. And the ratchets, I don't really have a standard. Yeah. I'm a young player, I rub feet and I light candles. Yeah. She love lemon drops and like to open toe her sandals. 21. Okay, 21. Come here, baby, let me coach you. Yeah. If you learn to do it with no hands, I might promote you. You know I got superpowers, I would never ghost you. We just made a movie, now we watching it on Roku.
Girls, 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 girls all over the some fun. Bad bitches round the world, better grab your one.
Girls, girls, oh. Girls, girls, girls all over the world. The world, the world.
She's a vibe and her friends a vibe. No, we bout to have some fun. Bad bitches round the world, better grab your one. Bad bitches round the world, better grab your one. Better grab your one, oh, oh. What up, Houston? What up, Dallas? What up, Chicago? What up, Cali? In Atlanta? I'm in New York. I'm in.
Girls, 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 girls.
some fun. Yo, bad yo, bitches on the really road, but I grab your one.